call them the P word.
Kumbaya. Yeah,
open this.
Well, they know that. They know they're pussies.
No, right. Hey,
that's not. That's not bad.
Yeah, Byers, no, it's not bad at all. No.
That's Byers, mean. Just jeez, pay me back mean. For 30 years of right. sponsorship.
No, but I mean, I just, I don't know. This is disappointed. Please welcome now to the program our old friend Larry King. Morning, Larry.
Morning. 50 years ago this Sunday was a television event that changed history. It was the night that 73 million people tuned in to see The Ed Sullivan Show and witnessed an act the likes of which they'd never seen before. Wells in the four phase. Comedic acrobats. What a routine. Gals in gorilla costumes, teeter board jumping. You don't see that kind of stuff anymore. Also on the bill that night, four people who had changed the course of pop culture as we knew it. Impressionist Frank Gorshin, magician Fred Capps, and the comedy team of Charlie Brill and Mitzi McCall. Nobody to this day does a Burt Lancaster like Frank Gorshin. Charlie and Mitzi, they were used judiciously as sort of a rest period to give the audience a chance to catch its breath. The Beatles were also on the show that night. I know because I was there as a Cub reporter for the Miami Herald doing a story on Tessie O'Shea, who was booked to do her famous banjo number, Two Ton Tessie from Tennessee. You know, Ed was instrumental turning so many acts into stars. If it wasn't for Ed, Topo Gigio would have just
ladies
been another rubber mouse with an Italian guy's hand
I
on his butt.
In the morning.
I've seen you right now.
The whole concept of a parade. Well, first of all, it seems fine to me. But I was thinking about it. I was coming down Fifth Avenue this morning, and it seems like you could take the people who are going to be in the parade, the St. Patrick's Day parade today in New York.
Yeah.
Which will start at 11 o'clock this morning, and it will last until 5 this evening.
Mm-hmm.
You could take them and put them on the sidewalk and let the people who are on the sidewalk march, and it wouldn't be... There's just a bunch of people watching a bunch of other people
walk.
It doesn't make any sense to me, does it?
Well, there's bands and everything. You have the bagpipes and the whole thing.
And now, and the gay people, they can't... They can't march, right? Well, they can march, they just can't carry their sign.
Right. Well, that's been the case for years. This right. has been going on in New York that they've wanted to, and they haven't been allowed to. And the Ancient Order of Ibernians, who runs the parade, haven't let them in. And it's always been upheld by the courts as a private event, and that's been the case for years. The only reason it's become a big story this year is because de Blasio, the new mayor, has refused to march to make a point. So,
do other groups carry their signs?
Of course. I mean, that's how the parade is. I mean, it's one group after another representing whatever organization. It could be a county in Ireland, or it could be a university. It could be a local school. And they, one after the other, as you said, usually led by some kind of band, Irish band with the bagpipes.
Do groups carry signs representing their political persuasion?
I don't think so.
I'm trying to think of
the heterosexuals. Do they have a
no.
sign? Do they
no,
march?
No, no, no.
I don't think
no,
there's
no,
a group
no.
like that that we would know of, is there?
No, none of that.
No. Warner, why do you have on green today? You're not Irish. I'm Irish.
Well, actually, my mother was Irish and converted to Judaism about 100 years ago.
Mazel tov.
So we have Virginia. I think that's where Tony went to school.
Green bagels.
We have Wichita State.
Yeah.
We have Arizona.
That's right.
And we have Virginia.
That's right. Florida. Right.
I mean, Florida.
Yeah.
Virginia twice.
And Florida will win the national championship, right, or no?
Could be. They're favored.
No, they are.
Yeah.
Okay.
But you have a couple surprises. A lot of people want to know why Louisville, 29-5, was a number 4 seed. Should have been higher, perhaps.
Yeah.
And then New Mexico, 27-6, was no better than a number 7 seed. You're not going to please everybody, obviously.
Sure. Even what happened to SMU?
SMU out. Not in.
Weren't they a ranked team?
Yeah, 23-9. But the problem is they lost their last three games to good teams.
All right.
But most people thought they would get in. Instead, they're the number 1 seed in the NIT.
Guess who's back this morning on the Iverson Wayne program?
Who?
The Cardinal.
Oh, right.
The Cardinal returns this morning.
Hey.
On the St. Patrick's Day, 2014.
Hey. You like that?
Top of the morning.
Yeah.
Well, the Cardinal will be coming up in a little while there.
All right.
And Tony and Rob are in the back trying to come up with anything. So, Bo Deedle's here, and so will Anthony Mason. He's coming up as well. So, where's the plane? They found that yet?
Nope. No, they have not.
They have any clues?
You know, it's along the same lines of what we talked about last week. I mean, you don't want to say that all signs do point to something happening with these pilots. I mean, it's just a matter of something The only other possibility, because I mean, you look at the fact that the communication systems were turned off, but now they've figured out, and they admitted as much yesterday, that they had a last communication with the pilots where they said, all right, good night. And then after that, they turned off one of the communication systems, but the other one had already been turned off. So the timing's weird. In other words, they turned off a communication system, then they spoke, then they turned off the other one. So that's basically where we
are. Pretty much ruled out, essentially, over the weekend that it was an accident.
Right, exactly.
That has been ruled out.
Something deliberate, whether it's them or...
Well, and do we still think it's in the water, or we don't? We don't know.
We don't know.
That they don't know.
Don't know.
Well, it takes a runway of at least a mile long to land it. Is that right?
Yeah, mm-hmm. It was a jumbo jet.
Yeah. So where are they going to... Yeah. And then Deirdre told me that there was something wacky about the lead pilot.
Well... Right. Oh, go ahead, Bernie.
Well, he was apparently the day that he flew that night, he went to a trial of the opposition leader of the current prime minister, and he actually at one point wore a T-shirt. There's a picture of him. The T-shirt says, "Democracy is dead."
Yeah.
And that guy was sentenced to 5 years in jail for homosexuality, whatever the hell that means, in Malaysia.
Yeah.
And he was a fervent supporter, and he was angry about it. So maybe reading something into that. Maybe he had a political motive, or they don't know. But that's the weird thing about him. And he had a simulator in his house,
right,
which is not all that unusual.
Right, as a pilot.
Unless he was teaching somebody how to do something with him.
So we actually showed the video on Fox Business when Bernie was talking of the pilot, and that was him in front of his simulator, I believe. And they've taken that, and they're looking at that simulator now for clues, anything, you know, whether he was preparing in some way to do something in his house.
Now,
so,
well, what do you think, we could find the plane?
Of course, but
it's unbelievable.
It's goofy, isn't it? Hey, how'd that vote go in Crimea?
Oh, man. 96, 97. It was a one-sided affair.
Oh, it was.
It was a Kim Jong-un, like, situation.
That kind of deal.
They voted in favor of secession, big time. So, and we're not recognizing it. The U.S. says, we will never recognize this.
Not.
So maybe more sanctions. We'll see. That's what the president's threatening.
Dagan, what do you have coming up?
I have a look at the weekend box office. The market's looking good to start the week, too. We like them.
What is?
The market. Stocks. Futures. Giddy up.
Oh, okay, well. And so, Warner, you're going to more about the Final Four. Now, when does the game start tomorrow, right?
Tuesday, that's right. You have they're called the play-in games.
Right.
So
when do we have to – and do we have to sign up a Tony or
– Well, I always suggested make it simple. Since nobody knows nothing, you pick get 68 guys. Each of them put in $10. You put 68 names in a hat, you pull them out, and somebody wins $680.
Who?
What?
What?
Sounds good.
You have 68 teams. You get 68 people. They each put in $10
a piece. No, I don't.
Oh. What
I didn't mean to, no.
You meant why.
Yeah, that's probably what I should have said. Why?
What?
I meant what, but I meant why. I meant just...
Well, there can be no...
That's a rhetorical observation.
Oh, I see.
What?
Yeah, it's not requiring any kind of answer.
680.
Oh, God.
Divided by...
It's pi r squared.
Okay, well...
So you're going to fill out your bracket, I man, later this afternoon?
I don't know. Bernie, what do you have coming up,
man? Well, we have Willie Nelson talking about legalizing pot. He was on with Jimmy Kimmel Wednesday night, and it was actually funny. And also, big news about the man with the... Formerly with the 132-pound scrotum.
Hmm.
We have some news about that poor guy.
God.
He's dead, isn't he?
You just gave it away.
Yes. I just gave it away? What do you mean he's dead?
Some news about him.
That's the news.
Well, if I know that, everybody knows that. I don't know anything. I have to get...
They're showing a picture.
What is the
point of this?
Why do we have to see that?
I'll tell you why he died. How about that?
God forgive us.
Oh, my God.
Whoa. Tom.
He caught her. Look at that.
That's the guy.
I know that's the guy, but I mean, why do we have to see it?
Why not?
I don't want to. Because I don't want to see it.
Well, we have some video of it also, if you want to see that.
We're all going to hell
anyway.
It's
going to make me throw up.
The part with the milk crate and stuff, and he has to put it down.
I'm not sensing any sympathy on the I-Man's part.
And then we have Mike B. Elvis coming up.
Dagan
has a song, so does Lou and Tony.
All right.
Guns, Rob, and the I-Man. We all have songs.
Wow, this is going to be great.
And Rob's is pretty good, actually. So. The goal is to pick something on Mike B. Elvis. It's supposed to be songs that are not already hits.
Right.
One would hope. rather than like Tony does or Lou. They all seem to be okay this morning.
Anybody pick Wild Colonial Boy or a good Irish song this morning? No?
No, they haven't. But we will be playing some Van Morrison, I would suspect. So, but I mean, who knows?
Right.
So the goal for this, for the Might Be Elvis songs, is to get one that we'll put in the power rotation on the Iverson Morning Program. All right, 14 after the hour, let's do some news now about where the plane is and whatever else is going on. Morning, Colonel.
Morning, Iman. Well, there's one other big story we haven't talked about yet. With these Navy SEALs took control of a hijacked commercial tanker. This was last night. It was being held by a group of armed Libyans. This is in the Mediterranean waters off the coast of Cyprus. According to the Pentagon, nobody injured in the operation. Now, the tanker was said to be flying a North Korean flag loaded up with oil thought to be owned by the Libyan National Oil Company. So the Navy SEALs now in control of that. Talked about Ukraine. President Obama says that Crimean vote to secede from Ukraine and join Russia will never be recognized by the United States. He says he told Vladimir Putin as much when they spoke yesterday. More sanctions possible, but Crimea, yeah, it was overwhelming. The election committee there says 97% voted in favor of the referendum. Yeah, so it wasn't very close. Anytime you can get 97%, you're doing pretty good. Investigators in Malaysia looking for this missing plane says when someone from the cockpit said those final words, all right, good night, one of the communication systems already was off. The other turned off just after that. So here's ABC News aviation analyst Steve Ganyard saying that all these indicators pointing the finger at a very skilled pilots.
All these things occurred at the handoff between Malaysian and Vietnamese air traffic controllers. They knew that it was this dead zone in there. They knew that they had some time to do all these premeditated actions.
Right, so they were examining this flight simulator from the pilot that Bernie talked about a minute ago. And then in New York City, the new mayor, Bill de Blasio, the first mayor in about 20 years not to march in the big St. Patrick's Day parade, which will start later this morning. Now, he's sitting out, as we talked about, because organizers don't allow gay people to march with pro-gay signs.
Big gay?
And a,
No,
de Blasio, no.
Well, he's marching because they won't let him, I see.
He won't, yeah. So the other story, Guinness was a big sponsor last night, announced they were pulling their sponsorship. Heineken also not sponsoring the parade this year. And some gay activists say, hey, that's a big financial hit.
Well, how do you sponsor the parade?
Well, it takes money to put it together. It's a privately run. Ancient Order of Hibernians runs the parade.
You have to pay the people to march?
No, you don't have to pay the...
Well, what is the money for?
People to march. Well, there's... it's organizing events associated with the parade. Yeah, there'd be parties and all that kind of thing. And
Guinness signs and ads and stuff.
Yeah.
Abound.
Oh, all right.
By the way, it tastes like leprechaun urine, this Guinness anyway.
Yeah, so...
It's really awful.
Is it?
It's terrible.
Heineken, I used to drink Heineken.
Trying to picture what leprechaun urine would...
I always thought Heineken was pretty good.
It's probably green.
I used to keep a cooler of Heineken in the limo.
You ever have any leprechaun urine yourself?
Huh?
Did you ever have any leprechaun urine?
No, I don't. Well, I would have.
Maybe.
Back in the day,
leprechaun semen.
I like Heineken, so.
Sure.
I wonder if that means less vomit in the streets today. That's an upside.
Yeah.
There is that. So you want to hear this? Some of these activists.
Sure.
Activists say these sponsors, Heineken and Guinness being out, it's a big financial hit for the organizers.
We've been fighting on this issue for, this will be the 23rd year in New York City, and it's not over until every Irish LGBT person can march down the street behind a banner that says who they are as a full and openly included member of the community.
There you go. So up in Boston, by the way, similar story yesterday. The mayor.
Well, I'm not for discriminating against anyone under any circumstances.
Mm-hmm.
But I don't know. I don't know.
It has the whiff of a little bit of a bullying tactic.
A little bit.
Yeah.
Oh. But I don't know. 17 after the hour. What's going on in business, Dagan?
Good morning, sir. The market's rough week last week. The Dow losing 387 points. Worst week since late January. But the futures are up this morning. 88-point gain on the Dow futures. The animated movie Mr. Peabody and Sherman won the weekend box office. A weak opening for Need for Speed, that new Aaron Paul movie.
Who goes to see an animated movie other than like a 12-year-old?
And the parents.
Right.
Frozen, big hit. All these animated films kind of have an adult angle to them.
They do?
Yeah,
they're horrible.
Huge movies.
They are horrible. I have to sit through them sometimes.
The only thing that was decent was Toy Story. Anything that followed that. That and Shrek. Anything else was just garbage.
Frozen was good.
You saw it?
What was it about?
It was about this princess.
Yeah, my kids.
It was a song. It was a.
Well, they're all about a princess.
For kids, it's good. But
well,
yeah.
Aunt, Mr. Peabody and Sherman isn't about a princess.
No, was Shrek.
Well, there was a princess in Shrek.
Yeah.
Sure.
Sure.
Oh, you know who had a horrible weekend though? Tyler Perry.
What?
The new Tyler Perry movie, The Single Moms Club, opened in fifth place, $8 million. That is the worst opening for a Tyler Perry movie. 9 years and 17 movies. That was bad.
Hmm.
There you go.
Sorry to hear that.
To start the week.
All right, 19 after the hour. Time for sports, sponsored by Peril Spoilers. Now, here with that is Warner Wolf, and Warner has an interest in the March Madness, which I've decided now I do as well. It's fun, so because Warner went to American University in Washington, D.C.
That's right.
And they're in.
They're in, man. So. They play number two, Wisconsin.
Yeah.
I also went to George Washington the first 2 years.
Sure.
And then transferred to American U.
Are they in?
And GW is in.
Oh,
yeah.
Warner.
So I've got a doubleheader going here. But the number four, number one seeds, 32-2 Florida in the South, 34-4 Arizona, even though they lost Saturday night to UCLA, 34-0 Wichita State in the Midwest, and as you know, 28-6 Tony Powell's Virginia Cavaliers beating Duke yesterday, number one in the East. Again, a lot of people surprised that 29-5 Louisville gets no better than a fourth seed in the Midwest. Here was Rick Pitino Saturday after winning, and now they won 12 of 13 after winning the American Conference.
We're probably going to be a one seed. The run we're on, I would say, we certainly fit the eye test. If we don't get the one with the type of February we're at, we're probably going to get a two.
Wrong, Rick Pitino. No. Number four. And left out, 24-6, Wisconsin Green Bay, and 23-9, SMU. So 31 of the 68 teams, I-Man, are from the Big 12, Pac-12, ACC, Atlantic 10, and Big 10.
Sure.
And tomorrow we have the two play-in games, Mount St. Mary's and Albany, North Carolina State, Xavier. NBA, Clippers 11 in a row, Spurs 10 in a row. Novak Djokovic comes from behind to beat Roger Federer, 3-6, 6-3, 7-6, to win $1 million and the Indian Wells California Championship. Total all-time now, Federer leads 17-16 in their head-to-head matches. Oh. Carl Edwards wins the rain-delayed Bristol 500. One delay at the start was 2 hours. Another delay, 3 hours. So what did Edwards do during the second delay?
I slept. I went up in the holler and I slept. You're always nervous when you go off to sleep somewhere because then when they call you back to the car, you know, you worry that they won't get you back to the car.
Wake up!
Ricky Stenhouse Jr. was second. Danica Patrick, 18th. And Dale Jr., who had tire trouble, was 24th.
What kind of tire trouble do you have? Here
is Dale Jr. on the tire trouble, explaining it.
I don't know what to do when the damn tires will stay on. The left front tire kept tearing up run after run. We didn't have no problems the first 100 and some laps. Started tearing up. Something happened to the car. I ain't sure what it was.
Uh-huh.
I hate when that happens.
Yeah.
So. Something on the car is rubbing your tire, and it's tearing the tire up.
Yeah.
That's probably what happened.
And no doubt.
That doesn't help.
And that's what I was thinking.
I have no idea what that was.
Yes. That would seem to me to be fundamental to be able to get the tires to stay on your car, wouldn't it?
Yeah.
I don't understand that, and they give you all the tires you want.
I hate when the rubbers come off.
Yeah.
Not anymore than the woman hates it, Bernie.
Child support.
I can kind of get an idea where the Cardinals going to be going this morning. Rob Bartlett and Tony Powell, by the way, appearing at the Tarrytown Music Hall this Saturday, March 22nd. Now, I asked Rob how the tickets were going this morning, and they're not all sold out, which I don't understand. So, but he said, well, they're about three-quarters gone. But I would suspect that because they promised, they have both said 80% new material.
Mm-hmm.
But that's just not going to be possible.
What?
Do you think?
But no, I have no doubt. No, I never doubt Rob or Tony.
Yeah. But there will be probably some new material.
Oh, of course.
And even if let's just say there's no new material.
Mm.
You probably were drunk the last time you saw him anyway.
Yeah, so. What do you care?
And it's been a year. And the demo on your audience is such that you probably forgot anyway. So go to tarrytownmusichall.org and go see them Saturday night. I mean, it'll be fun.
Very fun.
All right, 23 after the hour. Did you tell me what's coming up in the briefing, Bernie?
Yes, sir.
You did?
Yes, Willie Nelson. He's going to make you laugh, okay. Your friend.
But she's not going to call in, is she? Well,
apparently not.
Well, this discussion we're having has been going pretty well, I thought.
Well, we thought we had this all arranged yesterday.
I hope I don't get busted in the future. I just left her a message on her voicemail.
Bernard McGurk.
I'm producer Bernard McGurk was found.
Hey, give me a call, will you, baby? I'm waiting for you. That's the way I left the message.
That's great. It'll be all over.
I'm in trouble.
That's McGurk. McGurk.
That's all you need, Bernie.
Well, we got screwed and not the way we wanted to. So here we are. Great news, the Cardinal is back, and it's coming up this morning on this St. Patrick's Day, 2014.
Mm-hmm.
So, and this portion of the program is sponsored by Cars for Kids. That's Cars with a K. Donate your car today. It's time now, speaking of that, or something, to 31 after the hour for a Bernie briefing. And that's brought to you by MyPillow. Good morning, Bernard.
Morning, boss. And as Connell McShane reported earlier on this glorious St. Patrick's Day, Guinness has decided to pull out of the parade because the organizers won't let gay people march with signs proclaiming their sexuality. And Mayor de Blasio had already established that position. He's not marching. Mayor Bloomberg commented on de Blasio's position. Take a listen to Mike Bloomberg.
And I think by boycotting it doesn't get it done. If anything, it hardens the views and makes it more, it makes it harder for anybody to change if you force them into a corner. That's just not the way I would do it.
So little Mikey sort of echoing the I-Man's sentiments of moments ago, that it hardens people's sentiments. And Governor Rick Perry, Texas Governor Rick Perry, who you also like, boss.
Yeah.
He was on with Jimmy Kimmel last week. They had an interesting exchange about guns. Take a listen.
Now, I want to ask a few things because I found some interesting things about you, and I find them hard to believe. You once shot a coyote while you were jogging. True?
That's true.
You jog with a gun.
I do interviews with a gun.
And while he was there, they talked
that's
about...
That's a good line.
That's a good line. Yeah. He's kind of glib. He also talked about legalizing marijuana, did Governor Perry in the state of Texas. And Friday night, from Austin, Texas, Jimmy Kimmel interviewed Willie Nelson, who lives in Texas. Take a listen to this.
The governor of your state, Rick Perry, was here on Tuesday, and I thought this was very interesting because he's been talking about decriminalizing marijuana here in the state. Not legalizing it, but decriminalizing it.
That's good.
Which is something. And he said that one of the reasons that he's changed his mind on marijuana is because he sees you and he sees how sharp you are at your age, and I'm not kidding. I mean, he really did say that. I think that's interesting that you've kind of made that impression on him.
Well, I was glad to hear him come out and say what he said, and I'd like to invite him to come on the bus and take a trip with us.
I don't think that's going to happen, but keep hope alive. And finally, boss.
There's nothing not to like about Willie, by
not at all. Not at all. By the way, Thursday night, he had a party at his house, and he mentioned by name two of your favorites, Billy Joe Shaver and Jamie Johnson were there performing at his house in Austin. And he performed a song called Smoke Me Up When I Die.
Roll me up and smoke me when I die.
Right, exactly right. It was very cute. And finally, on the St. Patrick's Day, boss, Jimmy Fallon had this to say about the parade. Pros and cons. Take a listen.
Pro, going to Ireland and finding a four-leaf clover. Con, going to Colorado and finding a seven-leaf clover. Wait, that's not a clover.
Wait a second.
Pro, hooking up with someone on St. Patrick's Day.
Ooh.
Con, the next morning have to do the walk of Seamus. Pro, St. Patrick's Day falls on Monday. Con, then it gets back up, falls again, stumbles around, says, I'm fine, then vomits and passes out.
And hilarity was just, the crowd went wild, trust me.
That's it.
Trust me when I tell you.
Yeah.
Well, he's killing in the ratings.
So
what do you have to say now?
Well, that was week one. Now we wait for week two for the numbers to come in.
Okay. Well, okay. Bo Diddle's coming up here is apparently one of Connell's favorite songs. Brady!
Or hit your arse on the way out.
I'm a man of the people.
The bailout program for boring radio.
Imus in the morning.
You can go with the flow when it comes to equity investing, or spark a change in your investment approach by adding diversification with an entire sector of the S&P 500, like utilities. XLU combines all the utility components of the S&P 500 into one ETF with liquidity, all-day tradability, and transparency. Ready to add diversification to your equity investments? Before investing, consider the fund's investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses. Go to sectorspiders.com for prospectus containing this information. Read it carefully. Visit us at sectorspiders.com.
NASCAR's about excitement. But tracking all the action and hearing everything from our marketing partners, the media, and millions of fans on social media can be a challenge. That's why we partnered with HP to build the new NASCAR Fan and Media Engagement Center. HP's technology helps us turn millions of tweets, posts, and stories into real-time business insights that help NASCAR win with our fans.
Deep within Key Largo, you'll see things that may surprise you. From the unspoiled wilderness of the Florida Everglades to the tranquility of John Pennekamp State Park, look below the surface and you'll find more depth in Key Largo.
Diamonds, the jewelry exchange, has half-carat solitaires for $4.99, 1-carat $9.90, 2-carat solitaires for $19.90, and 1-carat studs are $5.99. We have most sizes and grades of GIA diamonds guaranteed the lowest price. Buy direct, the jewelry exchange nationwide.
The perfect fit at the perfect price. Buy one suit, get two free at Joseph A. Bank. Choose from a huge selection of traditional and slim fit suits and get two free right now at Joseph A. Bank.
You need a website. Why not do it yourself? Create your stunning website today. Go to Wix.com. It's easy and free.
With Basic Talk Home phone service, you can make unlimited, crystal-clear domestic calls for just $9.99 a month, every month. But if you don't believe me, listen to this trustworthy grandfather and his golden retriever.
With Basic Talk Home phone service, you can make unlimited, crystal-clear domestic calls for just $9.99 a month. That's every month. No gimmicks.
How did you get my house?
Basic Talk. Just $9.99 a month. Call, click, or go to Walmart today.
This is the Imus in the Morning program on the Fox Business Network. Now, here's Lori Rothman.
Good morning, gang. We have a deal in the telecom industry to tell you about. Britain's Vodafone Group is buying Spanish cable company Ono for nearly $10 billion, and that includes the debt. The deal will boost Vodafone's mobile phone business in Spain with fixed-line services and pay TV. It's also the company's first major deal since the recent sale of its 45% stake in Verizon Wireless to Verizon Communications. Ono is Spain's second-largest provider of broadband internet. Regulators must still approve the purchase. Now the weather. Spring starts this week. Hard to believe in many areas this morning. Here's your forecast with meteorologist Maria Molina in the Fox Business Weather Center. Hi, Maria.
Hi, good morning, Lori, and hello, everyone. We have winter storm warnings in effect early this morning across the mid-Atlantic, and some of you have already reported more than a foot of snow across sections of the state of Virginia and parts of D.C. We are expecting as much as 5 to even 10 inches of snow out there. On the warm side of the same storm system, we have severe weather that's possible for cities like Daytona Beach, Tampa, and even down into Fort Myers, isolated tornadoes, strong winds, and also hail possible out here with some of these storms. Temperature wise, well below average across the Great Lakes and also the Northeast, but across the center of the country, already feeling like spring, 60s and 70s in Texas, and upper 80s farther west across parts of Arizona. That's it, back to you, Lori.
Thank you so much, Maria. Quick check of U.S. stock index futures pointing to a big rebound after the worst week for U.S. stocks in a couple of months. Dow futures up an even 100 points right now. I'm Miss in the Morning continues right now on Fox Business, giving you the power to prosper.
Here at the Iverson Morning Program. The Cardinal returns this morning. That is coming up next hour. And also, might be Elvis. Everybody's picked a song. We'll play them and then try to come up with one that makes a power rotation on the Iverson Morning Program, although it will be just primarily an opportunity to ridicule people. So please welcome now for his weekly visit to the Iverson Morning Program, Bo Deedle. Good morning, Mr. Deedle.
Good morning, and happy St. Patrick's Day. I'm wearing the green for all my friends out there. I ain't no Irish guy, but I give respect and attention to all the great Irish people out there who have done great things for this country, and a lot of my friends. And a little shout-out to my ex-partner, Tommy Collarin. He's up above. He passed on a while ago, one of the great Irish-American cops.
So what does St. Patrick's Day mean if you're a cop?
Well, you know, St. Patrick's Day is just funny. When I came on the force back in 1970, I wasn't Irish, but you become Irish very quickly, and we would march in every St. Patrick's Day parade because, like, I had gone into plain clothes, so when you were getting all these medals and all that stuff, you couldn't wear them any other time except for the parade. You pin all this stuff up there, and we used to call it a rack of mora because it was a rack that went up to the shoulder. Some guys would have double racks. And we'd march, and then we would drink, and we would go after the young nurses over there and some of the parties. And it was fun. You're 21 years old. You had these beautiful Irish nurses. You marched down St. Patrick. We used to be able to drink in the bars before political correctness came into play. And, a couple of times, a couple of guys shot a couple of guys. But, you know what? Nothing real serious. Nothing real serious.
They kill the people they shot.
No. A little misfires, they call it. And then my brothers, my great Irish firemen brothers, good fist fights between the cops and the firemen. I mean, this was really the great part of St. Patrick's Day when men were men. Now all of a sudden become a defuncation with Mayor Big Bird there. All of a sudden he doesn't want to march. Give me a break. March in a parade. All right, we all understand our political correctness. I support it. You support it. But give me a break, all right? March it there. Don't put people into the corner like a rat. Hey, against the wall, you rat. You do it my way or no way. You don't do that. You march in a parade. You express your feelings and all that. Hey, we all know about the mayor's, wife was a lesbianic. At one time, she was a lesbianic. We all accept everybody. We accept everything in this country, in this world. March in a parade already. Don't be a buffuncation.
No, you wouldn't want to be that.
No.
So you're a pretty good detective.
I don't know how good I am.
Well, I think you are. Where's the plane?
Well, you know what? With all the evidence that we all are hearing, it's very obvious. It wasn't that the plane went and crashed. It was shut off. These responders and all that was shut off. But I got a problem. Why should they allow somebody in the plane to shut a responder off? For what reason? The only time you want one of these responders to shut off is if you're going into a congested area. And they ask him. That's the thing I'm talking about. Exactly.
Well, I just want to make sure.
Do I look like a freaking aeronautical engineer?
Well, no, I'm not either.
You knew what I was talking about, so you're trying to defuncate me?
No, you're just wrong. Okay, no, I wasn't trying to correct you. All right. I just wanted to make sure. But you
transponder, Don.
You're a...
Whoa.
Can't say...
Well, wait a second. It's St. Patrick's Day. Why are you talking like that?
Because you can't say anything to anybody.
Transponder. I take my correction.
Okay.
Transponder. Now, why should the pilot be able to shut it off like that? It has to go back on after 10 minutes automatically. This is a ridiculous thing. Now, the transponder was shut off. Yeah. All these factors that the plane was pinging for several hours later. It's very obvious something in that cockpit controlled either the hijacking or the other side of it is one of these pilots turned freak out. I don't know. Maybe the young guy turned freak out. The other part is, and with a lot of respect to my man from Brooklyn there, Senator Schumer, he says a lot of mumbo jumbo. Yeah. But he said something good yesterday. Why in the world they have a database out of Interpol where they can run 40 million names of suspects, terrorists, people, criminals, and all that? Why doesn't every airline, every country do it? United States, England, and I think Arab Emirates are the only three countries in the world that checks a database. Why aren't we checking database? This is after 9/11. Duh. Why don't we check these things? And then if you have a stolen passport, that would pop up. You have someone that wanted, that would pop up. I mean, this is just standard operating procedure. Yeah. And it's wrong. And the one thing I got to give Schumer credit, sometimes he mumbles on. Every Sunday he comes up with a new venture.
Yeah.
This was a very, very good point. And, you know, I was at the play, Rocky, on last week with your friend Michael. Michael took me to the play.
Michael who?
Michael from the New York Post that comes on here tomorrow.
Michael Riedel. Well, it could be Michael Lynn. It could be Michael.
No, Michael Riedel, the Post.
A date.
Yeah. We didn't go on a date. He had a beautiful lady. I had a beautiful lady, Margot, with me.
Okay, don't get
defensive.
You
stop with the late date?
You went on a date.
What are you trying to say? What are you trying to say?
I don't know. What
Bernie?
Are you trying to say, Bernie?
Bernie, what are you trying to say, Bernie?
I'm trying to say you sound very defensive right now, Bo Diddy.
Yeah. Oh, well, what are you trying to say? A little.
Well, no, but I mean.
Double really? Tracking over here? No. First of all, yeah.
Will you be marching in the parade? I guess not, right?
Yeah, maybe I will. All I know is he's one of the smartest. Michael's one of the smartest journalists. He knows everything about Broadway history. I mean, he just absorbs history.
Did he have a woman with him?
Yes, a very pretty lady. And I'm going to tell you something else. You know who comes over?
Or, as we like to refer to her, a beard.
No, will you stop it? Listen to me. We march. Listen to me. We go to dinner at the Great Gallagher Steakhouse over there. And then we march over to the Rocky thing. We see Stallone. Of course, you know, Sylvester was going to play me back in 1986. And he goes, hey, Bo, you know, I was just talking about you the other day. I was supposed to be you in that friggin' movie, One Tough Cop. And he says, yeah, I took another part of some guitar player or something in one of these movies. But it was a great, exciting play. Now, you would think right away, Rocky, how can it be a musical? Oh. It was great. The actor that plays it was great. The one that plays the girlfriend there and all that.
Oh.
Don, it was a very, very entertaining play. Surprisingly entertaining and enjoyable.
Hmm. And he's in it. Sly?
No, Sly came on the stage. He was out there in the audience there. And
he's not actually in it, though.
No. He's, I think, one of the creators of it.
Oh, sure.
Yeah.
It's a musical?
It's a musical about Rocky, and it's very, it's surprisingly great.
Yeah.
Because, like I said, Rocky, you think.
Are the reviews in on it yet, are they?
Yeah, I think it got three, four stars on some of them. Yeah.
How many stars can you get? I guess five, right?
Yeah. You know, Don, there's one other issue.
Three wouldn't be great.
No. Well, I tell you what, three's better than two.
That's very good point.
Yeah. Now, you know what, Don?
Yes, three would be better than two.
Right.
We're out of time.
One more thing, please. Have you been in restaurants lately? You go to restaurants.
No.
Okay. iPhones. Don, you got people. I'm watching people.
I got to go.
Couples. Leave the iPhones on. There's no communication anymore. We've been enveloped by these friggin' iPhones. Enough. Throw them away. America's being destroyed by iPhones.
Here come the Sensibles, six super friends on a mission to give your kids thrills and chills while teaching valuable money skills. Saturdays at 11 on Fox Business Network. The Sensibles, the fun way to teach kids about money.
Weekdays are for rising to the challenge. They're the days to take care of business when possibilities become reality. With CenturyLink as your trusted partner, our visionary cloud infrastructure and global broadband network free you to focus on what matters. With custom communication solutions and responsive, dedicated support,
We constantly evolve to meet your needs every day of the week. CenturyLink, your link to what's next.
Today on Opening Bell, EPA Power Play. Will coal and gas get burned by new regulations? Maria clears the smoke with Peabody Energy CEO. Then, a toast to the green in your portfolio. Celebrating St. Pat's Day with the best whiskey stocks. Varney's buying a...
There's a mystical island in the Eastern Caribbean called St. Lucia.
Where you'll find three sandals, the most romantic resorts on planet Earth.
It's the luxury included vacation that makes you go, wow.
A lot.
Where exceptional suites are the rule.
And adventure is included.
So, and this portion of the program is sponsored by Cars for Kids. That's Cars with a K. Donate your car today. It's time now, speaking of that, or something, at 31 after the hour for a burning briefing. And that's brought to you by MyPillow. Good morning, Bernard.
Morning, boss. And as Connell McShane reported earlier on this glorious St. Patrick's Day, Guinness has decided to pull out of the parade. Because the organizers won't let gay people march with signs proclaiming their sexuality. And Mayor de Blasio had already established that position. He's not marching. Mayor Bloomberg commented on de Blasio's position. Take a listen to Mike Bloomberg.
And I think by boycotting, it doesn't get it done. If anything, it hardens the views and makes it more, it makes it harder for anybody to change if you force them into a corner. That's just not the way I would do it.
So Little Mikey sort of echoing the I-Man's sentiments of moments ago, that it hardens people's sentiments. And Governor Rick Perry, Texas Governor Rick Perry, who you also like, boss.
Yeah.
He was on with Jimmy Kimmel last week. They had an interesting exchange about guns. Take a listen.
Now, I want to ask a few things because I found some interesting things about you, and I find them hard to believe. You once shot a coyote while you were jogging. True?
That's true.
You jog with a gun.
I do interviews with a gun.
And while he was there, they talked
that's
about...
That's a good line.
That's a good line. Yeah. The guy's got a, he's kind of glib. He also talked about legalizing marijuana, did Governor Perry in the state of Texas. And Friday night, from Austin, Texas, Jimmy Kimmel interviewed Willie Nelson, who lives in Texas. Take a listen to this.
The governor of your state, Rick Perry, was here on Tuesday. And I thought this was very interesting because he's been talking about decriminalizing marijuana here in the state. Not legalizing it, but decriminalizing it.
That's good.
That's, which is something. And he said that one of the reasons that he's changed his mind on marijuana is because he sees you and he sees how sharp you are at your age, and I'm not kidding. I mean, he really did say that. I think that's interesting that you've kind of made that impression on him.
Well, I was glad to hear him come out and say what he said, and I'd like to invite him to come on the bus and take a trip with us.
I don't think that's going to happen, but keep hope alive. And finally, boss.
Nothing not to like about Willie, by the way.
Not at all. Not at all. By the way, the night before, Thursday night, he had a party at his house, and he mentioned by name two of your favorites, Billy Joe Shaver and Jamie Johnson were there performing at his house in Austin. And he performed a song called Smoke Me Up When I Die.
Roll me up and smoke me when I
die. Right, exactly right. It was very cute. And finally, on the St. Patrick's Day, boss, Jimmy Fallon had this to say about the parade. Pros and cons. Take a listen.
Pro, going to Ireland and finding a four-leaf clover. Con, going to Colorado and finding a seven-leaf clover. Wait, that's not a clover.
Wait a second.
Pro, hooking up with someone on St. Patrick's Day.
Ooh.
Con, the next morning have to do the Walk of Seamus. Pro, St. Patrick's Day falls on Monday. Con, then it gets back up, falls again, stumbles around, says, I'm fine, then vomits and passes out.
And hilarity was just, the crowd went wild, trust me.
That's it.
Trust me when I tell you.
Yeah.
All he's killing in the ratings.
So
what do you have to say now?
Well, that was week one. Now we wait for week two for the numbers to come in.
Okay. Well, okay. Bo Diddle's coming up here is apparently one of Connell's favorite. Everybody's picked a song. We'll play them and then try to come up with one that makes a power rotation. On the Iverson Morning Program, although it will be just primarily an opportunity to ridicule people. So, right. Please welcome now for his weekly visit to the Iverson Morning Program, Bo Diddle. Good morning, Mr. Diddle.
Good morning and happy St. Patrick's Day. I'm wearing the green for all my friends out there. I ain't no Irish guy, but I give respect attention to all the great Irish people out there who have done great things for this country and a lot of my friends. And a little shout out to my ex-partner, Tommy Collarin. He's up up above. He passed on a while ago, one of the great Irish-American cops.
So what does St. Patrick's Day mean if you're a cop?
Well, you know, St. Patrick's Day is just funny. When I came on the force back in 1970, look, I wasn't Irish, but you become Irish very quickly, and we would march in every St. Patrick's Day parade because, like, I had gone into plain clothes, so when you were getting all these medals and all that stuff, you couldn't wear them any other time except for the parade. You pin all this stuff up there, and we used to call it a rack-a-mora because it was a rack that went up to the shoulder. Some guys would have double racks. And we'd march, and then we would drink, and we would go after the young nurses over there and some of the parties. And it was fun. You're 21 years old. You had these beautiful Irish nurses. You marched down St. Patrick. We used to be able to drink in the bars before political correctness came into play. And, you know, a couple of times, a couple of guys shot a couple of guys. But, you know what? Nothing real serious. Nothing real serious.
They kill the people they shot.
No. A little misfires. Misfires, they call it. And then my brothers, my great Irish fireman brothers, good fist fights between the cops and the firemen. I mean, this was really the great part of St. Patrick's Day. When men were men, now all of a sudden become a defuncation with Mayor Big Bird there. All of a sudden, he doesn't want to march. Give me a break. Oh. March in a parade. All right, we all understand our political correctness. I support it. You support it. But give me a break, all right? March it there. Don't put people into the corner like a rat. Hey, against the wall, you rat. You do it my way or no way. You don't do that. You march in a parade. You express your feelings and all that. Hey, we all know about the mayor's, you know, wife was a lesbianic. At one time, she was a lesbianic. We all accept everybody. We accept everything in this country, in this world. March in a parade already. Don't be a buffuncation.
No, you wouldn't want to be that.
No.
So you're a pretty good detective.
I don't know how good I am.
Well, I think you are. Where's the plane?
Well, you know what? With all the evidence that we all are hearing, it's very obvious. It wasn't that the plane went and crashed. It was shut off. These responders and all that was shut off. But I got a problem. Why should they allow somebody in the plane to shut a responder off? For what reason? The only time you want one of these responders to shut off is if you're going into a congested area. And they ask him to... That's the thing I'm talking about. You know exactly.
Well, I just want to make sure.
Do I look like a freaking aeronautical engineer?
Well, no, I'm not either.
You knew what I was talking about, so you're trying to defuncate me?
No, you're just wrong. Okay, no, I wasn't trying to correct you. I just wanted to make sure.
Transponder, Don.
You know, you're us.
Wait a second. It's St. Patrick's Day. Why are you talking like that?
Because you can't say anything to anybody.
Transponder. I take my correction.
Okay.
Transponder. Now. Why should the pilot be able to shut it off like that? It has to go back on after 10 minutes automatically. This is a ridiculous thing. Now, the transponder was shut off. Yeah. All these factors that the plane was pinging for several hours later. It's very obvious something in that cockpit controlled either the hijacking or the other side of it is one of these pilots turned freak out. I don't know. Maybe the young guy turned freak out. The other part is, and with a lot of respect to my man from Brooklyn there, Senator Schumer, he says a lot of mumbo jumbo. Yeah. But he said something good yesterday. Why in the world they have a database out of Interpol where they can run 40 million names of suspects, terrorists, people, criminals, and all that? Why doesn't every airline, every country do it? United States, England, and I think Arab Emirates are the only three countries in the world that checks a database. Why aren't we checking database? This is after 9/11. Duh. Why don't we check these things? And then if you have a stolen passport, that would pop up. You have someone that wanted, that would pop up. I mean, this is just standard operating procedure. Yeah. And it's wrong. And the one thing I got to give Schumer credit, sometimes he mumbles on. Every Sunday he comes up with a new venture.
Yeah.
This was a very, very good point. And, you know, I was at the play, Rocky, on last week with your friend Michael. Michael took me to the play.
Michael who?
Michael from the New York Post that comes on here tomorrow.
Michael Riedel. Well, it could be Riedel. Michael Lynn. It could be Michael.
No, Michael Riedel, the Post.
A date.
Yeah. Very nice. No, we didn't go on a date. He had a beautiful lady. I had a beautiful lady, Margot, with
me.
Don't get
defensive.
Will you stop with the late date?
You're one on a
date. What are you trying to say? What are you trying to say?
I don't know. What are you trying to say, Bernie?
What are you trying to say, Bernie?
I'm trying to say you sound very defensive right now, Bo Diaz.
Yeah. Oh, well, what are you trying to say? A little.
Well, no, but I mean.
Double tracking over here? No. First of all, yeah.
Well, you'd be marching in the parade. I guess not, right?
Yeah, maybe I will. All I know is he's one of the smartest. Michael's one of the smartest journalists. He knows everything about Broadway history. I mean, he just absorbs history.
Did he have a woman with him?
Yes, a very pretty lady. And I'm going to tell you something else. You know, comes over.
Or, as we collectively refer to her, a beard.
No, will you stop it? Listen to me. We march. Listen to me. We go to dinner at the Great Gallagher Steakhouse over there. And then we march over to the Rocky thing. We see Stallone. Of course, you know, Sylvester was going to play me back in 1986. And he goes, hey, Bo, you know, I was just talking about you the other day. I was supposed to be you in that friggin' movie, One Tough Cop. And he says, yeah, I took another part of some guitar player or something in one of these movies. But it was a great, exciting play. Now, you would think right away, Rocky, how can it be a musical? Oh. It was great. The actor that plays it was great. The one that plays the girlfriend there and all that.
Oh.
Don, it was a very, very entertaining play. Surprisingly entertaining and enjoyable.
Hmm. And he's in it. Sly?
No, Sly came on the stage. He was out there in the audience there.
Oh, he's not actually in it, though.
No. He's, I think, one of the creators of it.
Oh, sure.
Yeah.
It's a musical?
It's a musical about Rocky, and it's very, it's surprisingly great.
Yeah.
Because, like I said, Rocky, you think.
Are the reviews in on it yet, are they?
Yeah, I think it got three or four stars on some of them. Yeah.
How many stars can you get? I guess five, right?
Yeah. You know, Don, there's one other issue.
Three wouldn't be great.
No. Well, I tell you what, three's better than two.
That's very,
right?
Very good point.
Yeah. Now, you know what, Don?
Yes, three would be better than two.
Right.
We're out of time.
One more thing, please. Have you been in restaurants lately? You go to restaurants.
No.
Okay. iPhones. Don, you got people. I'm watching people.
I gotta go.
Couples. Leave the iPhones alone. There's no communication anymore. We've been enveloped by these friggin' iPhones. Enough. Throw them away. America's being destroyed by...
Is that right, Bernard?
Yes, he has.
And it's Cardinal who?
Cardinal Egan, coming out of retirement.
Oh, wow, that's nice.
Cardinal Egan.
Yeah.
Very nice.
Wow. He's back.
So he'll be coming up, and we'll deal with that. So. I guess.
Certainly.
And then, might be Elvis, so, in which, we have Lou's pick.
Right.
Gunza's, Dagan's, Tony's, Rob's. And mine.
So. Should be good.
Well, it could be, so. But Dagan picked a bluegrass song.
Bluegrass?
Yeah.
Wow.
Bluegrass is played by people who are the product of people who were related through more than marriage.
Oh, it is.
Yeah.
It's good to know going in.
Yeah, they sit there on the porch or on the bridge.
Right.
With their banjos.
Yeah.
And they play bluegrass, which, by the way, nobody likes.
Nobody.
It's about five till the hour now.
I'm Imus in the morning.
White boy Pig Feast Dupree. What are you doing?
Warming up.
Okay. Where the Rob Ain't Got No Segment Blues. Don't do it.
Well, my dear close friend named Rob, been working for the I-Man nigh on 27 years. He's thankful he got a job and didn't end up like some has-been comic with one of those Where Are They Now dead-end careers. But the I'm in the morning broadcast journey consists of Dagan's business, brief ins from Bernie, Warner Wolf report the sports, while numbnuts Connell do the news. But poor Rob got cast aside by old Imus, he got been denied. He got them fat boy ain't got no segment blues. Meant to meet in blonde on blonde, Hollywood and Vine, only make old Rob respond. Everybody got one, so where's mine? Ain't on a panel of any from Queens, he think he getting a raw deal. perfect for my Beavis by all means. But the I Man did some worse than Deirdre Dooley's wheel. The whole staff has been assigned positions on a panel upon which they can't debate. But Fat Boy's reputation is being maligned, cause the I Man say that when he just being himself, he really ain't all that great. Though Rob won't stop from his campaigning or refrain from his complaining, I must think that it's entertaining that he's the only one on the staff he does exclude. And though the old cowboy is incorrigible, maybe Rob should weigh in on a subject in which he's more knowledgeable, like maybe a restaurant review, cause he sure got a lot of experience with food.
Ladies and gentlemen, Imus in the morning.
Well, just a few minutes. The Cardinal will be here, returning on this St. Patrick's Day, 2014. Dagan Scott Business News coming up, and one of his sports. It's Virginia, Arizona, Wichita State, and
Florida.
And Florida. So
that's it.
Well, kind of an unusual. Although Wichita State, they weren't they in the final last year?
Yeah, semifinal.
Yeah.
Lost to Louisville.
Oh, that's right.
34-0, but you know what? The odds makers don't have much faith in them. They're like the choices of they're down the hill.
Well, they're in a hideous bracket.
Oh. Yeah.
I mean, they have to play everybody.
That's right. They're 15-1 shots to win.
Even I could figure that out.
You're right. Yes.
And SMU, I don't know. I heard them all whining about that, but I don't know what it meant.
Well, they're 23-9. They were ranked. But they lost the last three games, but people still thought they'd get in, including Larry Brown, the coach.
Yeah.
They lost to three tough teams, Houston, Memphis, and Louisville, in the last three games.
I wondered what happened to Larry Brown. I saw him interviewed on ESPN.
Mm-hmm.
He's, I guess he's fine, but just seemed, been a lot of places, hasn't he?
Oh, man. Wow. UCLA, Kansas, all the pros, 76ers, Detroit, Nets, Knicks. Yeah.
Well, I guess things are working out fine at SMU. Or?
Yeah. He's taking the program. They're very good.
Well, they get to play in the NIT, right? They still have that?
They're the number one seed in the NIT. That's okay, correct. So. Right.
That'll be fun for them.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So it all starts tomorrow. 68 teams.
Well, I have my invitation from Tony to join.
Yeah.
Did you get yours?
No.
Oh, you didn't?
No.
Warner doesn't do that.
I'm not doing it.
No.
I told you the best way you can have no shenanigans at all, as I say on St. Patrick's Day.
Very nice.
You just put 68 names in the hat.
Uh-oh.
You pay $10 a name, you pick it out, that's it. Somebody wins $680.
Oh, that's no fun.
You don't have to know anything. Nobody
no fun.
Nobody knows anything anyway.
Be quiet. I just got a very distressing email here from Imogene Lloyd Webber.
Oh, what happened?
She's ill.
Oh.
And may not be here tomorrow.
Oh, come on, Benny. What?
Wow, that changes everything.
So who do we get to fill in for, I wonder?
We have anybody available?
Wait a minute. Before we get to that, let's say, let's hope she's okay.
Oh, no. She suggested Rob in the email, which I was CC'd on.
Oh, wait a minute here.
Oh, you're kidding.
Rob?
You're kidding.
Yeah, Rob.
Sure, Rob's around, right?
Rob's on Might Be Elvis today. He's already got a segment.
Well, it's today.
Today.
This is tomorrow. Yeah, Rob would be great.
Sure, Rob would love my slot. Oh. There you go.
Oh, good one. Not over my head.
Well, right now it's Riedel and Dagan, and we have to find somebody to fill in for Imogen.
Nothing gets by Bernie.
Yeah, couldn't even think of that one.
Well, it's not going to be Rob. I mean, it's crazy. Why would it be Rob? What do you have coming up in business news?
Gas prices, baby, are they going to go down?
Laura, is that a green dress you have on? Or?
It's teal blue I missed. Yeah, I was going for green, but I think it's reading more blue than green.
Definitely blue. Blue.
Okay.
So. Sorry about that.
Thanks for nothing.
What did you do this weekend?
Guilty as charged. I took the little darlings to see Mr. Peabody and Sherman.
And?
Yeah, I liked it. Well, it's, you know, he's from the old Rocky and Bullwinkle cartoons, so not to date myself, but it was fun to go back there.
Did they like it?
They loved it. And all the historical references were great. My husband and I kind of got a kick out of it, too. Saw Frozen as well. It's out now. You can see it at home. So.
And did you like that?
Loved it. It's a great story. Feminists would love it, too.
This is really sad, isn't
it? I'm sorry. It's my life. Life in the suburbs. I'm a mom. Working mom. What can I say?
Barney, what's coming up in the briefing?
We have President Obama in a radio interview defending his mom jean look.
Hmm.
And did they find the plane?
No, but there's a little bit of new information that actually just came in about the pilots. They say now that they believe it was the co-pilot who spoke those last words. Right. And we said earlier, the guy said, all right, good night. And apparently one of the communications devices had already been turned off before he said that. They believe it was the co-pilot.
I believe my wife told me that the main pilot was a whack job of some sort. But
right. Well, Bernie was explaining that last hour, right, with his history.
All right, please welcome down to the IMS This Morning program.
Hold on. Hold on a second here.
Cardinal Egan, good morning, Cardinal.
Hold on, you schmuck, you be Jesus.
Get ready for this.
Hey.
All right.
Hey, hold on.
He's out of practice, the Cardinal.
Way too much.
Maybe we should have rethought measure, worked this out ahead of time.
The Cardinal can't get his headphones on.
Where are the altar boys?
The bloody case, you be Jesus. What the hell?
We need some. Matt, get over here.
Oh, we're not. Hey. What have you done here, Cardinal?
Here we go.
We're going to be off the air. Oh, my God.
Are you ready, fella?
Yes, God bless.
It's been a long time, I miss Lamar.
No.
Not long enough, you two-legged bag of snot, you be Jesus. Let me just say this. Still classy, I miss. Nice interview with that pornographic pig, Larry Flint, last week, be Jesus. I saw an unintelligible, filthy old pervert. Looks like he's 2 weeks away from death, be Jesus. And Larry Flint, he didn't look much better. I'll tell you that, I miss Lamar. On that up note, happy St. Patrick's Day to you all, be Jesus. Come on, let's hear it. Let's go. Lovely day, I miss Lamar. Pass around the cold ones, be Jesus. Pass them around. There you go, McShane. Yeah. There you go. Hit Dagan. What? Juan or Wolf?
Hey.
Guns, Rafino, be Jesus. Hand one over there to Dagan McDoomy, for God's sakes. The Nashville Nympho. Two or three of these and she'll be river dancing with no damn clothes on. I tell you that, I miss Namar. All right, suck them down, fellas. Suck hats. You're a good one you are now. My wild Irish, what rhymes with rose? The sweetest what rhymes with rose I knows. You buy them a drink, they'll give up what's pink. Oh, my wild Irish, what rhymes with rose? Of all the bull shenanigans, be Jesus, the whole lot of yous make me sick, be Jesus. I tell you that, I miss them all. Quick, McChane, hurry up. Make sure the I-Man's coffee's hot, you bootlicking turd, you. It's a good thing the I-Man shillelagh doesn't work. You'd be shining that as well, you sycophantic schmuck, you be Jesus. Oh, me name is Callum McShane. I am so boring and so bland. I play the role of flunky to the ugly old eyed man. Oh, Dagan McDowell, she blows the flute. I take it in the can. A family like the Mansons, the stupid Imus clan, be Jesus. Let me ask you this, Imus Lamar. Will you be marching up Fifth Avenue today?
No, I won't.
Of course not. You know that big bird Bill de Blasio, be Jesus. Thank the Lord. You can barely march to the bloody bathroom, you winded old weasel, you be Jesus. If you're Imus, get out of me parlor. There's no welcome there for you. And if your name is de Blasio the Putz, get out of me house, you filthy louse. I'd kick you in the nuts. All right, hey, Mr. Martin, you all make me sick, be Jesus. But time for a little prayer.
Oh, okay.
We can all join in.
Like
in the name
her.
Of the Father, the Son, the Holy Ghost.
Yeah.
I'm in an urn. We still want the most, be Jesus. The response is, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, we give thanks for the following. That Mayor de Blasio won't march. We've not a regret. We don't even wish he was on the Malaysian jet. Lord. Could have gone either way with that one, I missed the Lord. I'll tell you that.
Oh, God.
Lord, hear our prayer. Let's hear it.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, we welcome the gays without their signs,
yeah,
and care not what they do with each other's behinds. It's a free country, I miss the Lord. Yeah. Leave them alone. Yeah. Let's hear it. Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And finally, yeah, it's shamrocks and clovers and Irish luck on this day, and perhaps even the I-Man will pass away. Lord, hear our prayer. Let's hear it, you heathen bastards, just be Jesus. God bless us and save us the whole lot of you. Which doesn't belong and why?
Oh, God, I love this part.
Which doesn't belong and why? A, New York Mayor Bill de Blasio.
Bill de Blasio.
B, former New York Mayor John Lindsay.
John Lindsay.
C, former funny man Imus in the Morn. Which doesn't belong and why?
Obviously, Imus in the Morn.
Wrong, you Betty White-looking buffoon, you be Jesus. Well, all three of these once popular New York City liberals will not be marching in the St. Patrick's Day Parade. The answer, you ignorant lizard, is A, Mayor de Blasio doesn't belong, because unlike the other two, de Blasio does not have a dead wiener, be Jesus. Go on ahead, let's play the music now.
Coming up.
Enjoy, pass them around, pass the drinks around you, smack you.
Hey, Cardinal, here on the High Mission the Morning program. Time for some news now.
Here we go.
Oh, God. Look at what a mess.
Right, here with that is Colin McShane.
Oh, man, going? Good morning, I'm
mad. The whole lot.
I hate the whole lot of you.
Get his hat on. That'll be fine.
Yeah, good morning, I'm in. Some new...
Have a good time, Connell.
Some new information about the plane. Oh, yeah, that's a great way to start, Connell, after all this. The Malaysian Airlines CEO just came out and said that the it was the co-pilot speaking those last words to air traffic control. We'd said earlier it was the... they said, all right, good night, and then... One of the transponders was turned off, and then the other one was turned off after that. But the co-pilot, not the pilot, apparently said those last words. That's the newest of the information as they continue the search for the plane. Indian Ocean now is where a lot of it is centered, and Australia is helping to lead the search today. The Obama administration is trying to use all the buzz that's surrounding the NCAA basketball tournament this week and all the interest to get people to sign up for Obamacare. They're going to have videos from, you know, athletes. We're showing LeBron James on TV right now and coaches, and they're going to target some interviews on sports radio, put people out there, and some social media stuff as well, try to get interest up for for health care. So you have that. And then here in New York, as workers finished clearing the rubble from those two collapsed buildings last week in East Harlem, a number of people over the weekend gathered at local churches mourning those who were lost, and Lisbeth Perez lost her husband.
I learned so much from him. History, politics, music, whatever you want to talk to him, he knew about it. And he was the most romantic person, even though he was big and tall, but he was just so romantic. He told me every morning how beautiful I look.
Oh, man, 8 people died last week when those two buildings collapsed. So those are the big headlines this morning.
All right, little businesses now, quarter after the hour. And here with that is Dagan McDowell. Morning, Dagan.
Good morning, sir. Stocks are ready to bounce back from their worst week since late January. Dow futures are up 80 points at the moment. Gasoline prices also up 19 cents a gallon. That's the nationwide average in the last month. But good news, the rally has stalled, and prices are still 16 cents a gallon below where they were a year ago. But expect prices to heat up as the temperatures heat up this spring.
This portion of the IMS Wine Program at 16 after the hour is sponsored by Cars for Kids. That's Cars with a K. Donate, of course, your car today. Time for sports. Sponsored by Peerless Brothers. Here with that is Warner Wolf. Morning, Warner.
Morning, Iron Man. No surprises. 32-2 Florida wins the South. Number one seed, 34-4 Arizona, even though they lost the Pac-10 title game to UCLA Saturday. They get the West number one, 34-0 Wichita State, number one in the Midwest, but also in their bracket, Michigan, Duke, and Louisville. That's why they're only 15-1 to win it. And 28-6 Virginia, who beat Duke yesterday for the ACC title in the East. A couple of people upset, of course. SMU didn't make it. And defending champion, 29-5 Louisville, gets no better than a fourth seed. Here was Rick Pitino, who after winning the American Conference Saturday night, thought they'd be higher.
Hello,
Rick.
We're probably going to be a one seed. The run we're on, I would say, we certainly fit the eye test. If we don't get the one with the type of February we're at, we're probably going to get a two.
Wrong, Rick Pitino.
What difference does it make?
Well, You play a 13th team instead of a 16th team to open it up. That's really it.
So okay.
If you finish one, you play 16. A 16 has never beaten a one.
Yeah.
So NBA Clippers 11 in a row, Spurs 10 in a row.
Well, you ought to be able to beat a 13 team, shouldn't you?
Should. Yes. Although 13 teams have beaten number four.
Mm-hmm.
Novak.
Yeah, but if you thought if you really should have been a one or two.
Yeah.
You really are a one or two.
Play
just
like
so you get that number.
I see. Just play like a one or a two.
Yeah.
Okay, I'll buy that.
Okay.
Djokovic beats Roger Federer, 3-6, 6-3, 7-6, wins $1 million and the Indian Wells Championship. Carl Edwards wins the rain-delayed Bristol, Tennessee 500.
Make me watch that.
Delayed over 5 hours. Ricky Stenhouse Jr. was second.
Oh.
Danica Patrick, 18th. And finally, man, on this St. Patrick's Day, talk about a stacked deck. St. Patrick's Day, 1923, having no chance of a fair deal. Light heavyweight champion Battling Siki from the Senegal, a World War I war hero, fought the challenger, Irish Mike McTeague, on St. Patrick's Day in Dublin, Ireland, with an Irish referee who was the sole judge of the fight.
Nice.
Needless to say,
that's courage.
Battling Siki lost his title and the decision.
Irish Mike.
It's all 19 after the hour. Bernie, what do you have coming up?
Obama and his mom jeans.
Now for my Elvis, in which everybody has nominated what's supposed to be an up-and-coming song. What are you looking at?
Is what? You're cutting your eyes at me. It is an up-and-coming song.
Okay. And so we'll start with it. Bigfoot, you're going to play these, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. What's the delay there?
What? What delay?
Jesus.
Oh, man, this old. This
so
old,
anyway, so the first will be Lou's.
Old? Okay.
Under what category, Lou?
I have pop.
Okay, and your song is what?
It is Brendan Benson, Rejuvenate Me.
Okay, why did you pick this?
Well, Brendan Benson, good friends with Jack White. He's got a few records out. He's a great writer, great songwriter, great performer. He's in the Raconteurs with Jack White.
Okay.
And he is really very accomplished. He's great.
Okay, well, let's listen. Here we go. Bigfoot. What'd you think, Guns?
I think it's pretty good. It's nothing, you know, nothing on it actually stood out to me, but it's a good song. It's a good jam song. Why not? Yeah.
Dagan?
Jack Whitey enough to make it good.
Yeah.
Particularly for pop music these days.
Good to drive in a car and listen to.
Yeah, it's a good jam. Not, you know, nothing amazing, but it's a good jam.
What did you think, Johnny? Same thing I thought, right?
Resuscitate Me?
Yeah.
Pull the plug now.
Hey,
yeah.
Wow.
Yeah. Don't use the paddles, just let me go.
Yeah.
It wasn't awful, Lou. No. So it wasn't awful. All right. Here's Guns pick. Guns, you picked what? American Authors, hit it?
Yeah, the name of the band's called American Authors. They're from Brooklyn. It's a fun pop rock song, you know, got some energy to it. Just a fun overall song. Got an electric banjo at the end of it. And it's a song that really gets you moving. And what's wrong with that?
So. Okay, so you supported Lou's song.
Right.
I guess thinking he's going to support yours, right?
Knowing Lou, I would absolutely expect him to support my song.
All right, let me hear this, Bigfoot.
Some say if you don't go, then you won't know how to let go when you gotta let it swirl. Some say if you don't try, then you won't know how to get by. No, said it wouldn't hurt. Oh, no. If I then you dropped out, so you got a lot to learn. But I say, pick it back up, throw it on now, make it stack up, because tonight we're gonna burn.
Now stop the music. You know, Bigfoot.
Yes.
You had a week to prepare to do this segment, didn't you?
I did. Well, actually, no. I mean, we got the songs on Thursday or Friday.
Okay.
So, less than a week.
So I'm looking at the monitor.
Yeah.
And it isn't any different than last week.
No, there are a bunch more pictures of the groups. I mean, these aren't the easiest people to find, trust me.
Yeah, that's kind of the point.
But wouldn't you think? I mean, it works fine on the radio, thank God.
Thank God.
But I'm just wondering if...
Praise God.
Well, a lot of it is, you know, seeing the pictures of the groups, but also seeing the reaction of everybody on, you know, whether or not they're into the song or not.
What did you think, Rob?
I think it's the kind of song that you play when you're living in your mom's basement while you're playing Warcraft, eating pudding.
Come on.
And touching yourself, maybe.
Come on.
Just a Wednesday afternoon for
Can
Guns.
Can I ask a question, though? Is that off the new album from American Authors?
Yeah.
That's a hit album, so it's disallowed. Disallowed, schmuck.
I thought it was
first
top
of all,
10.
No, it's a hit album.
Too bad. Sorry, the Gunn, song that was
going to here's the first thing. Daisy May doesn't get to decide anything.
Disallowed.
You're lucky you're on the panel. Be quiet. Oh. You want to be off the panel? You want to be off the panel, yes or no?
Yes or
okay,
no.
There you go.
Oh, wow. It's getting ugly.
That was not the
you
right
can't
answer,
disallow Gunn's song.
It violated the rules that you laid out for us.
No, it didn't.
Yes, it did.
No, it did not. It's not a. It can be a hit album. It's not a hit song, right?
Right. Absolutely not a hit song.
No, 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 no.
It cannot be on the top 10 of any list on iTunes.
The song can't.
And the album.
And the album.
No, I never said the album.
Oh, yeah, you did.
I changed the rule.
You did change the
rule. Guess what I did? I changed the rule.
Just happened.
Well, good. I guess we can swap out my previous choice.
No.
That song is...
What did you think of it?
I want to choose the Beatles.
I liked it. It was fine.
I sort of liked it, too. So what did you think, Lo?
I was trying not to be so distracted by Guns' silly dancing in there.
I was into just, the moment.
Yeah, no kidding. But I liked it. Yeah, I liked
very
it.
Very much
good.
Like at the club, Guns was dancing by himself again.
So, sitting down. Again, the goal is to come up with a song. The goal is to come up with a song that might make the power rotation of this program. Mm-hmm. It could be anything. So we play a lot of different stuff. So.
Mm-hmm. But that would
just
never...
have to be Jamie Johnson.
No. That would never make the power rotation on this program.
This?
No.
That's not nice.
No.
This is a song chosen by a man who drinks a liquor drink out of a straw.
Hey, you can't be drinking no liquor drink out of a straw, Gunn.
And you know you were doing it over the weekend because you put a photo on Instagram of it, you loser.
Did you do that?
Well, I took a picture of the margarita, but
with
I didn't drink out of
a straw in it.
You got it,
did? Yeah, not even a little small story straw, but a long straw. You could see the lipstick stain off it from you.
That is really horrible, John.
That's pretty
is
bad.
Is that true?
I don't recall that part,
man,
but
you broke your man.
It was one of those fishbowl margaritas. So.
Now, Dagan, you picked who?
I get more embarrassed by the day.
A groovy bluegrass jam band, the infamous String Dusters. I'll Get Away. It's off their new album coming out April the 1st.
I've already heard it.
Yes, you have.
Well, let's play it again. Don't you say. Decide.
What you doing, where you going, tossed by the winds that are blowing. High time you went inside. For a long time I've been trying, even thought that I was a flying. High time you let it go, if it's worrying you've been feeling, over things you can't control. Hey, it's time to let it go, if you think you can make a difference, and the fire is in your soul.
Go ahead and take your stand, and
if you can't, then let it go. Yeah, just let it go.
What's the matter?
It's great if you're in a car chasing a Bonnie and Clyde movie. I mean,
that's the whole point, man.
Listen a little bit more.
What?
Yeah. Are they gonna sing again ever?
More.
The path that you've been making ain't the one you wanna be taking. Step back and look inside. If you stumble on the gravel, find another road to travel.
I don't hate it, actually.
Oh, wow.
What do you think?
It's got a good beat, but I can't dance to it.
I said I'll Get Away. I think the name of the song's Let It Go.
It's not bad.
Oh, now it's much better.
Guys, what did you think?
Let It Go. Let My Life Go after listening to that. Come on now. No way.
Okay, Lalo.
It's the kind of, if I started hearing that while I was driving some unfamiliar place, I'd start turning around and drive the other way. Yeah. I'd kind of be scared.
Yeah. Like, you got a real party mouth there.
It's getting a little dark in here.
Well, I think it was awful. I mean, I don't know if we played or not, but
they're great live. They're at the Bowery Ballroom, March the 27th. There you go.
Tony's been hating on everybody. Here's Tony's pick. It's called You're My Star by Tank.
Oh, God.
The album's already a hit, right?
No.
The album's a hit. You're lying.
The album's not a hit. Okay. I had to dig deep to find him, but
he's got a hit.
He may have one.
Singers,
that's what isn't that their job to get put on? I had to dig deep to find this guy. I mean, first of all, I'm not a big fan, but there was something about it. I just had a 70s style vibe. It reminded me of the Jackson's Heart Break Hotel. That's why I picked
it. Let me hear it.
Never know. I would rather die than let you go, girl. Can't describe this feeling in my soul. And I can't help but stare. You got that glow. And let me get a little bit closer.
Really, that's enough of that. That's not bad.
Yep.
So, Rob?
Yeah, let me borrow that. No, my brother, you got to get your own.
That's not terrible.
Would it help guns get in a girl's pants? Maybe. So it's pretty good.
I know. It's got that vibe.
What do you think?
It's got a vibe to it.
It was good. I liked it. It was great.
Yeah, it's not bad.
Yeah. Very convincing, Lou.
All right, Rob, your pick right now?
The Fratellis. She's
Why?
Not gone yet, but she's leaving.
Well, sure.
She's leaving, but she's quite sure she's not the only one. She's not gone yet, but she's leaving. Well, there's a quiver up the backbone, dogs in the dust. She's not gone yet, but she's leaving. And she'll take what she needs and she'll do what she must. She's not gone yet, but she's leaving.
Oh, that's enough of that. That sucks.
What?
Sucks. That'll be stuck in your head for the rest of the day.
What?
Okay.
That's an earworm.
Tony?
I like it, though. I did like
it. Oh, you're just sucking up for Rob.
This is atrocious.
I hate it. How about that?
It's more Rock than Guns picks. So yeah. Thumbs up.
Guns, what'd you think?
I think it's not going to be a hit. I mean, it doesn't scream at me, but it's fine. You know, whatever.
Lou? What's it going to scream at you?
Loser!
The band is great. I like the band. Yeah, actually. The band. I know them, and I think it's good.
And here's the I-Man's pick, Mickey Guyton. It's called Safe.
Mickey?
Bigfoot.
I like
it is,
him.
It is safe. It's pretty good. Nice.
Really good.
It's kind of slow.
The storm is calling. Rain's falling down like tears. Hey. The water's rising. Bringing on my darkest fears.
Lock me in a safe.
Oh, she's
got
lucky.
One on me.
She's lucky she's cute.
Yes, she is hot.
You don't like that?
You know, it sounds a lot like
Bigfoot, can you hear me? You know, the idea of you playing this stuff, Bigfoot, is a problem because, one, you don't take the cues. Mm. And then I talk, you don't know what I mean? Oh, God.
I'm sorry, did you need me?
No.
Did you like that?
Yeah, it was all right.
Was all right.
Yeah, I mean, didn't
it represents black on black crime from you.
Oh.
So.
It's pretty voice.
What category was that in?
Country.
Was that funerals?
You guys all suck it out. Why that they can't, you ask him to do something. Now they're not. Where's Rob?
You're talking about Rob and Tony?
Yes.
Why, what did you ask him to do?
I asked him to help me to find out what my password is. On the Starbucks account.
Can I ask you a question, by the way? Why do you have two? Why do you have an iTouch and an iPhone? But don't you have a Starbucks app like on your phone?
Yeah.
So why don't you just use that? Doesn't it work?
Yeah, it works fine.
So why don't you just
Well, because I have $160 on this.
Oh, I see. Why?
I don't know.
That's the question.
And I don't even know what credit card it is. It's not my regular credit card.
That's why you're not supposed to put so much money on them. You know?
Why can't you figure this out?
I don't know what you want to do.
I want to find out what my password is.
So you forgot it.
They didn't send it to me.
Well,
contact them again. I gave you all my passwords, all this stuff. Figure it out.
By the way, you made a big transfer from your checking account. Thanks for the password.
God.
God,
the problems you have.
Well, no, but I mean, that's a simple.
Doesn't make sense why you would have two phones, one with $160 on it.
I don't know. I can't remember now why I got the iPod Touch. No, I bought it.
Why, though? There's no reason even.
Well, I don't know why I bought it.
Unnecessary. There's no reason to have an iPod Touch.
There isn't, is there?
No, you got a phone. You can do it.
Ladies and gentlemen, Imus in the morning.
Yeah. So this is really unbelievable.
What?
Well, first thing, have we found a plane yet?
No, we have not.
Do we have any idea where it is?
No, we do not.
Is it in the water? We don't know.
Nope.
We have no idea where it is.
No clue.
All right, it might be Elvis. We got to eliminate some people. They're throwing way too many songs. So, first of all, Dagan was great on it.
Mm-hmm.
And the next good was,
Two Seed.
That was Tony.
Tony's the two.
Tony was good.
The Two Seed. All right.
And then Lou.
Lou's three.
And then who else was good, Dagan?
Yes, Dagan?
Dagan couldn't judge before, but now she can judge us.
You're going to ask Dagan to judge the other. No. Other
Dagan's my little friend. I'm asking her.
Oh, is my mic on? Rob and Guns were both good, too.
Yeah. Rob is not good.
Nice answer.
Oh, very well said, yeah.
Rob is making fun of a person in a wheelchair. That's not funny. So.
Not, no, you're right.
So this is, we're in the kitchen at the apartment,
mm-hmm.
and Alex, who's the chef out at the ranch, during the summer and during the winter, she works in the greenhouse and does other stuff with Gabe, who's the head farmer at the ranch. So Alex, we grow jalapeno peppers in the garden at the ranch. So Alex, she puts them in a jar and pickles them or something. Pickles the jalapeno peppers.
Got it.
And it says on the jar, pickled jalapeno peppers.
Okay.
So Deidre is fixing me. She's a great cook, by the way, Deidre. So she's whenever she has time to do it. So she's fixing me this salad.
Mm-hmm.
So she says, would you like some of Alex's pickled jalapeno peppers?
Right.
And I said, yeah, I would. I said, how are they?
Uh-huh.
She says, you're an
a-hole. Whoa, hold on.
Wait
a minute. A what?
She called me an a-hole.
Oh, no.
Had to beat me there. Just out of nowhere.
Just out of the blue.
Because I asked what they were like.
Huh. There's not any more to the story than that.
No, there's not. No,
probably not.
And she was just. So then I just called her off the air.
Uh-huh.
To try to find out what her password is to.
And how did that go?
She's still irritable. So she gave me the wrong password. It's not the...
Right.
Her one password, well,
you could say her password on the air.
I was going to, but no, I'm not going to, no.
Definitely don't want
to... I think she spelled the word wrong, so...
Maybe.
So here we are. So we have no idea where the plane is.
No, we don't.
We don't know why SMU didn't get into the to the NC2A March Madness deal.
Well, they lost the last three games.
Oh, they did, yeah. And it starts tomorrow.
Right.
Well, I have to admit, I said last week I wasn't jacked up about it, but I am.
Good.
It's a fun week, couple weeks, 3 weeks, whatever it is.
3 weeks, right.
Yeah. And the final four teams are who are they, Warner?
Oh, the final four?
Florida, Arizona, Wichita State, and Virginia, right?
I don't know if Wichita State will be the final four. Because
well, that's the number one seeds, rather.
Oh, number one seeds, yes. But Wichita State, I mean, gosh, they're in the seed with Michigan, Duke, and Louisville. I don't, man, that is the toughest.
And Kentucky.
Kentucky in the Midwest. That's the toughest seed.
No.
The Midwest. I mean, you really got to play to get out of there.
Yeah. So you don't think they're going to make it?
No.
Well, the 34, no, they haven't lost any games, right?
That's correct.
Well, who did they play? Did they play anybody?
I think the toughest team was Indiana State in their own Missouri Valley Conference.
That's the one Larry Bird used to play for?
Indiana State, yes.
Not anymore.
Very good.
But she doesn't play there anymore.
No.
Unless they have 70-year-old students. Right.
As Rick Pitino once told the Celtics, Larry Bird and Parrish are not going to walk through the door when they were losing.
Mm-hmm.
Remember that?
That's a good point.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe you don't remember that.
I thought Rick Pitino, whatever happened to that When he was manager, when he was coaching the Knicks.
Yeah.
He used to have that bald spot on the back of his head, you know?
Patino?
Yeah.
Maybe.
Because one time I was trying, when I said NBC, I was trying to sell advertising on it. So.
The bald spot?
Yeah.
Very creative. Yeah.
But trying to get Marv or somebody to help me do that. So
always thinking.
Mm. Well, that's an easy hair transplant if it's just a small bulb.
But now it's gone. That's no longer
sure.
there.
So. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And, but that was the year he just had to throw up three-pointers, yeah. and they did well.
Yeah. What do you have coming up, Dagan?
I have a look at Nissan. It's selling some electric cars. They're hot. Why? I'll tell you.
Okay. Lori, what do you have?
Market's looking good today. Risk on. Take some bets. Buy some stocks. That's what everyone's thinking. We've got Alibaba with its IPO details. So people are optimistic about that. A big deal as well in the telecom industry. So investors like that. They like that stuff is happening, that deals are flowing, and that money's moving. And so we're going to come back from probably what's looking like a pretty tough week last week.
You've been doing the mornings with us now for how long?
I think this is my fourth week, going on a month or so.
How do you like it?
I'm coming around. The alarm is going off, and I'm getting up with a lot more ease. Thanks for asking.
Why, every time I ask you something, do you say, thanks for asking? Well, I'm just kind of curious.
Because I'm flattered that you care, simply put. Because, you know, you got a lot of plates to spin in the morning.
Oh,
so.
That's for sure.
He really doesn't care.
What indication did you get that I cared? Right. I'm just kind of curious. Care.
Thanks for asking.
I like you, but
just,
I mean.
No, I appreciate that. No, see, I did it again. Maybe it's a crutch. Maybe it's a nervous thing. I'll try not to thank you ever again.
Well, no, I just wondered why.
You're right to be nervous, though. Don't worry,
we're all nervous.
Yeah, because anything could happen at any time. Mm-hmm. So.
It might.
Bernie, what do you have?
I have Snoop Dogg and Willie Nelson in Amsterdam, and Jane Goodall says that Michael Jackson was spanking his monkey, Bubbles.
Son of a...
True story.
Yeah.
You know, the guy who represents the ranch, the attorney who represents the ranch, and has from its inception... The Imus Cattle Ranch Kids with Cancer is John Silver, who in Santa Fe, New Mexico. He's a great guy, fifth generation Santa Fe. One of the former tennis pro, one of the nicest people I ever met in my life, and a very competent lawyer. And he runs the Jane Goodall Foundation. That's one of the other things he does. So I could get some insight into this.
Oh, yeah.
Or has Miss Goodall just... How would she know that Michael Jackson was beating his monkey?
She was at Neverland. She claimed she confronted him. Well, I'll tell you in the briefing coming up. I'll give you all the details.
She goes around, you know. Have you ever seen her?
I saw her the time she came in here with you. And this is a woman who was in the wild with gorillas and apes. And she was afraid of you. Not the gorillas or the apes. She was intimidated by the Iron Man.
She goes around with a little stuffed monkey, you know.
Yes.
So
she's a cute old lady.
She's lovely. So why I did know her? I don't. I met her a couple of times. The girl seemed crazy to me, but in a good kind of crazy, not bad crazy.
Yeah.
So. All right. Time for the news here at 13 after the hour. And with that, Connell McShane. Morning, Connell.
Well, good morning, Iman. Before we get to the latest on the plane and some of the other big stories we have
today. What do you do today? You're Irish, right?
Yeah.
Well, so am I, kind of. I'm far
Irish. I'm just going out with
drunk
the
or what?
Kids. No, with the
stick
family.
Stick a potato in your pants. Remember, it goes in the back.
Hey,
that's
hey,
everything.
Hey, oh, no, take it easy. Take it easy. Take it easy.
Remember, it
those
goes
are going
in the back.
Right, Dagan?
Oh, well delivered.
Hey, Carly.
Okay. Well delivered, Iman.
That's a good one.
Whatever.
Remember, it goes in the back. Carly.
Paging are you home. Irish, Carly?
I'm not.
Okay.
Not even a little.
What are you? Do you know?
I'm half Puerto Rican, half Lithuanian.
How about that?
Okay.
Wow.
That how is about... a party right there.
Sounds like...
What would you say?
That is a party right there.
Okay, very well could be, so.
Mom and Dad.
How about some coffee?
Getting it on. Okay.
All right.
Yep.
Here's Connell with the news. Morning, Connell.
Good morning, Iman. So this is, as I said, before we get to the big stories, I don't know if Warner will have this later, but it just came in. I know you'll be interested in this.
Oh.
The Indianapolis Colts owner.
Yeah, I got that.
You do,
hey,
Warner?
Why don't you pass on that?
All right. So Warner will have this coming up. What do you hear who's in jail? They just handed it to me, so I thought you might
want to. Oh, what is it, Warner?
Oh,
ahead,
good
Warner.
Tease. Your favorite guy.
Oh, man.
Your favorite person of all time.
This is great.
Colts owner Jim Irsay has just been jailed in Carmel, Indiana, after being stopped for drunk driving.
Oh, how great is this?
That's it.
Make your day.
And nobody's putting up a bail.
He is such one of the all-time All-time creeps. Yes.
All like that time.
One. You'd like that story. So that's the big story this morning. And, you know, in terms of the plane, investigators in Malaysia are looking, of course, for the plane in the Indian Ocean for the most part now, they're telling us. But we had this story about when someone in the cockpit said these final words that we know of, all right, good night. All right, good night was the quote. One of the plane's communication systems had already been turned off before somebody said that. And the other was turned off after it. Well, the latest information that came in this morning, this is from the Malaysian authorities, it was the co-pilot, not the pilot, the co-pilot who spoke those last words. So search continues. So that's basically...
Hey, Lou, do you ever read Bob Raisman in the New York Daily News?
A lot, yes.
I like Raisman. I've always liked him.
Liked him a lot. He's very good.
Do you know who gave me the nickname the I-Man?
Was it him?
He did.
Oh, okay.
You know who gave Chris Russo his name, Mad Dog?
Thinking it was probably Bob Raisman.
It was Raisman.
Oh.
Were you aware of that?
Wow.
Yes.
Did you read his column on Sunday?
I didn't read his. No, I didn't read Raisman yet.
Well, he is suggesting, Raisman is. He's pretty smart about this stuff, I think. I think he is. That by Francesa going on Fox Sports 1, which provides him with a national audience, that he now is going up against ESPN.
ESPN television.
Yeah. And that Fox Sports 1, part of their motivation is that Raisman has maybe he was kidding, but he has positioned this as Francesa taking on ESPN in a ratings battle.
Why not?
Was that?
Well, wasn't he up against them before, too?
Well, not really on, you mean
on Yes. Well, nobody got Yes.
Yeah, that was a mom and pop operation.
But it was,
was regional.
That's a nanny cam deal.
Well,
the Yes Network.
No, this is for real.
Not serious. Fox Sports One is serious.
Yeah, more homes and everything.
Yep. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
But not as many as ESPN.
Fox Sports One is in 87 million homes, and ESPN's in 97 million. So that's pretty much a jump ball. To employ a sports analogy, a
very
metaphor,
good one.
Right?
Oh, well done.
Well,
so, yeah, is that an analogy or a metaphor? It's a metaphor.
But a little bit of both.
Metaphor, oh, okay. Sure. So,
could be a battle.
Now, what does ESPN have on at 1 to 3 in the afternoon? Hmm. Not much, do they?
I'm trying to think.
No.
Like Sports Center, right? Until at some point, and then they have some.
Later on, they have that awful show around. Isn't it Around the Horn on that?
Hey, now.
Hosted by
boy.
Yeah, Connell's friend.
That is a terrible show.
That show is
it's
really
fun. My
terrible.
Kids like it how they score the whole thing, and I like Tony. He's a great guy.
Well, he's going down.
I'm sure Tony's
well,
fine.
Not, he's not until 5, though.
But he's going down at the hands of Francesa.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
Well, Francesa won't be on Fox Sports 1 at 5. He'll be on Fox Sports 2, which, as you said.
You'll find this missing plane in Malaysia before you find Fox Sports 2.
Exactly right. So he's only on Fox Sports 1 from 1 to 4. So.
Right.
Be different.
Anthony Mason, CBS News, is coming up. Who...
This sounds like Francesa's show, talking about the ratings the way we're going on.
I'll give it a 3,
I love Francesa.
3-7 in New York.
I want Francesa to win.
Of course.
Here is Anthony Mason's musical Mount Rushmore, Jimi Hendrix, the Beatles, Aretha Franklin, and Sinatra. Well, he's right about 2 of them, so.
Give it a 5-9.
Well, we'll talk to him about it. He knows a lot about that stuff, so, and I like him, so that's why he's on.
Very good.
What you doing in the news?
I was giving it
a
big attempt here. Well, I'll give you one more. On St. Patrick's Day, New York City Mayor Bill de Blasio with all the headlines here. First mayor
cares?
Since Dinkins 20 years back to not march in the parade. So
Don't march. We don't care.
Right. He's sitting out because, you know, the organizers, as they have not for years, don't allow gay people to march with pro-gay signs. And the other big story was Guinness, one of the key sponsors, pulled out of the parade last night.
So did Heineken. I used to drink that.
Heineken's out, too. Yeah, they're not sponsoring it, so that's it. But Enda Kenny, who's the Irish prime minister, or Taoiseach, he's marching here.
Oh, he is.
So.
They should let the gays march and just have them skip, so you know.
That's a very good suggestion.
19 after the hour, time for some business news. And to hear with that is, what's her name?
I don't know.
Dagan McDowell. Morning, Dagan.
Good morning, sir. The futures are still higher. Dow futures up 72 points, trying to reverse that nasty week last week. And Nissan may hit its target for electric car sales earlier than originally forecast. 1.5 million by the year 2020 is the goal it is trying to beat. This is happening because emission standards around the world are getting tighter, so we're all going to end up driving golf carts, pretty much. There you go.
All right, it's 19 after the hour. Let's do sports. And here with that is Warren Wolf. Good morning, Warren.
Morning, Iron Man. No surprises. The four number one seeds, 32-2 Florida in the South, 34-0 Wichita State in the Midwest, which is the toughest draw, including Michigan, Duke, Louisville, and Kentucky. 28-6 Virginia, beating Duke yesterday for the ACC title there in the East. And in the West, 34-4 Arizona, even though they lost the Pac-12 title on Saturday night to UCLA.
UCLA any good, or they just happened
to win
that game?
They're in there. They're not bad.
Okay.
So-so. I don't see it. They'll go too far.
How'd they beat Arizona?
More points.
Yeah, that's right. They outscored.
Really
an idiot. Yeah, I know. Now left out, 24-6 Wisconsin of Green Bay, and 23-9 SMU. Here was Coach Larry Brown.
This team has talent, but the other teams had a lot more character.
Well, get some characters.
You know, I watched the I went to True TV to watch the discussion about the brackets with Charles Barkley and Kenny, what's his name, and
Smith,
the other guy, and some other guy. And I'm surprised how much about college basketball that both Kenny and Charles Barkley know. Did you see any of that, Lou?
No.
Did you?
I did not. But, I mean, I've seen them in the past. They've done it the last few years because they do CBS, too. Split it. Yeah. But they're on it, huh?
Well, I thought they were, but I guess nobody saw them.
Steve Kerr, too. He's good.
I wonder how many people actually switched over because 60 Minutes was on then, which I seldom watch out, but... I wonder how many people switched over to True TV to watch them discuss them.
I'm guessing you're in the minority.
No, yeah, I don't think so.
A lot of people probably went to ESPN and see what they were saying about it.
Let's go to True.
Yeah. Well, they had a bracket discussion, too.
So. Right.
Yeah.
Hmm.
They're still talking about it.
Of course.
All right, well, go ahead, Warren.
Well, the other questionable call is Louisville, 29-5. And most people thought perhaps, well, at least they'll be 1-2. But they come in fourth seed. Here was Rick Pitino right after winning the American Conference title Saturday night.
We're probably going to be a one seed. The run we're on, I would say, we certainly fit the eye test. If we don't get the one with the type of February we're at, we're probably going to get a two.
You're wrong, Rick Pitino. NBA, the Clippers 11 in a row, Spurs 10 in a row. Novak Djokovic comes from behind, beats Roger Federer 3-6, 6-3, 7-6, wins $1 million and the Indian Wells Championship.
And they only have to play three sets.
That's right.
Yeah.
Yeah. Carl Edwards wins the rain-delayed Bristol 500, delayed a total of 5 hours.
Oh. Mm.
What did Edwards do during the second delay?
I slept. I went up in the hauler and I slept. You're always nervous when you go off to sleep somewhere because then when they call you back to the car, you know, you worry that they won't get you back to the car.
Wake up!
And in case you missed it...
And then everybody laughs like that's amusing.
Yeah.
Oh, God.
Oh, I don't know if you saw this over the weekend. John Daly, who last won a major, that was the British Open, 19 years ago, shot a career-high 90.
Took a 12 on one hole.
That's right, on the 16th hole. And the word is that Pistons' Joe Dumars, president of the operations, may be on his way out, and Detroit's favorite son, Isaiah Thomas, would take his place.
Oh, God.
As Knicks general manager, Thomas had a record of 241 losses, compared to only 141 wins.
Yeah.
And, of course, cost the Knicks $11.5 million sexual harassment case.
23 after the hour. Bernie, what's coming up in a briefing?
We have Snoop Dogg, Willie Nelson together in Amsterdam, and Bubbles the Chimp getting beat up.
Here, Thomas Vance. Well, you may not be able to stop time, but with bags and puffiness under your eyes don't need to be there. So. But now, thanks to Genucel, you can get rid of them naturally and without surgery. That's right. The new Genucel stem cell therapy for bags and puffiness under the eyes from our friends at Chamonix are doing just that for the men and women all across the country. Got a letter from Josie out there in Littlefield, Arizona. And she writes, I've been using Genucel for 2 weeks now, and my husband is amazed. He says, all the puffiness is gone. And I said, I love this product so much, I'm going to use it on my entire face. Girl got a puffy face, apparently. And her husband said, What you trying on that big old butt of yours, girl?
Oh, is that what he said?
Well, maybe not, so. Jenny, you sell worse, guaranteed to your money back. Call them, 800-754-6980. That's 800-754-6980. If you will order it right now, they will throw in a jug of that esoteric Bernie briefing. And that's sponsored by MyPillow. And here with that is Bernard McGurk. Good morning, Mr. McGurk.
Morning, Mr. Imus. This guy wrote a book. His name is Jack Gordon. He wrote a book about the Jackson family, a tell-all, as they call it. And in it, he wrote, quote, Michael beat Bubbles up a lot. I saw him punch him, kick him in the stomach. The chimp was on the ground crying. Michael used to say, he doesn't feel it. He's a chimpanzee. I have to discipline him. Well, a lot of people didn't know if that was true or not. Well, Jane Goodall, the famed ape...
The monkey lady.
Yeah. She was at an event in D.C., and some idiot from TMZ caught up with her. The reporter's a moron. Listen to him. Anyway, he caught up with her, and he asked her about Bubbles the chimp. Take a listen.
When I was growing up, Michael Jackson had one, and I always wanted to have one.
I picked him off. I went to see him, and we talked about Bubbles.
Oh.
Oh, yes.
What was the best thing about Bubbles?
Bubbles is still alive and he's very beautiful. But when he was with Michael Jackson, he was being beaten.
Did Michael ever teach him how to dance? Okay, thank you. So, have a good day.
So she said when Michael was with Bubbles, he was being beaten. And she said she ticked Michael off by confronting him. And this idiot goes, did Michael ever teach Bubbles how to dance?
Good follow-up.
It's nice. a good non sequitur. But in any case, there's your confirmation. Jane Goodall, Michael Jackson.
Beating the monkey.
He was a spanking the... Yeah, right, exactly right.
Mm-hmm. Well, it's not amusing. Okay. Of course they feel it.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm going to poke him in his eyes. Look, he won't even blink. Look at this. And... Well, let's see, boss. Willie Nelson.
Sure.
He was on with your friend Jimmy Kimmel.
Yeah.
And they were talking about Snoop Dogg and a couple of things. Take a listen.
What else do you and Snoop Dogg do together?
Well, you know, we have sung together. He mm-hmm. sings on this song of mine called Roll Me Up and Smoke Me When I Die.
Mm-hmm. And is there a chance that might happen? I mean, are you... If it happens, you would like to be smoked by Snoop.
Well, I could give a... Well, I might make another list over here, but...
I would imagine
that... No, that would be, Snoop is a good buddy, and we've hung out together. First of all, he come to Amsterdam, and we hung out over there. So
that seems like a good
very
thing.
Very well acquainted over there.
That seems like a fever dream. I was with Willie Nelson and Snoop Dogg in Amsterdam.
Like Charlie Sheen getting together with Amy Winehouse, if she was alive.
Well.
But you were talking Friday, boss, about Lindsay Lohan's, she had this, she left a note in a bar of all the people she slept with, 36 people or something like that. Somebody got a hold of it, published it, and your friend David Letterman was talking about it on Friday night.
Sorry, you know Lindsay Lohan. The woman has had 36, sex with 36 celebrities. And right now, they got a hold of the list, each one of these celebrities being tracked down by the Centers for Disease Control. The list has gone viral, and of course, so has Lindsay.
That's mean. Mm. That is just plain old mean. And finally, boss, your friend Jimmy Fallon, the number one talk show host.
Yes, just as I predicted.
Here he is from Friday night with some laughs.
A new survey found that 21% of Americans say religion isn't that important to them. Then God said, looks like 21% of Americans are about to have a really bad hair day. Facebook founder Mark Zuckerberg apparently called the president directly to complain about the NSA and how it spies on ordinary Americans. That's right. You heard that right. The guy who runs Facebook got mad at the NSA for spying on people. Talk about the pot unfriending the kettle.
And the crowd went
nuts. It's probably not the monologue that's doing it, but he is number one by a long shot, right?
That's right.
Okay, just as I thought. So you're thinking that's going to go away.
No, I'm just saying we should wait, reserve judgment, let the dust settle, and in about 6 months, then we can crow or eat crow.
Yeah, 6 months to a year, because it is painful to watch. I tried to watch it on Friday night, and it's you can't get through the monologue.
Oh.
It's bad.
That's too bad. I'm sorry to hear that. Anthony Mason is next.
Apparently somebody has paid for this.
Yeah?
Called Larry King dropping in.
Timely.
And Larry was talking today, of course, about St. Patrick's Day. Please welcome on the program from CBS News, Anthony Mason. Good morning, Mr. Mason.
Good morning, Mr. Imus. Happy St. Patrick's Day.
Did you happen to hear Larry King there?
I found it a little puzzling, but I did hear it. Yep.
Okay. So he was talking about what some friend of his who had a 10-year-old daughter who was singing on St. Patrick's Day, Danny Boy, and I don't know what she thought it was about, but she didn't. I don't know. Well, my point of bringing this up is, why not get Larry back at CNN? Hmm.
Well, you know what? Given the ratings they've been getting, it might be an improvement.
Wouldn't it?
Yeah.
In the past 3 years, I mean, Larry's been everywhere.
Yeah, I know. I don't know. I mean, I think I understand why they let him go when they did, but given what they've tried since and how poorly it's worked, that, you know, it's tough to go backwards, but obviously what they've been doing hasn't been working very well.
Anthony Mason is CBS News Senior Business and Economics Correspondent, and he hosts the CBS This Morning on Saturday. He's on the CBS Evening News with Scott Pelley, and he also is on the Sunday thing with Charles Osgood. So
they're getting a big bang for their buck is what they're getting.
Where do you go? Do you live in Manhattan?
No, I live in Westchester.
Do you come in every day?
Yeah.
And where do you go? Do you go to 57th Street?
I go to 524 West 57th Street, way over between 10th and 11th Avenues, yeah.
And so what will you do today?
Well, today I actually took the day off. I don't get a lot of them, but I took this one. But normally, typically I go in. I mean, I like this week, I'm filling in for Charlie Rose tomorrow morning and Wednesday morning, and then I host the Saturday show, and this week I'm also hosting Sunday morning. And in between, I got about 3 stories to write.
Well, man, now they're going to use you. They'll use you up.
That could be a song.
Yeah. So where's the plane? Do you know?
I mean, can you believe this?
No.
I was actually surprised over the weekend. Bloomberg came out with something. I think there've been I was amazed at how many planes have actually gone completely missing that they've never found. It averages about one a year.
Really?
I mean, talking any planes over the side that carried 14 or more passengers, they did a survey of it. And they're actually, it actually averages about one a year going back, I don't know, about 40, 50 years. And, but I mean, how do you lose a plane?
Well, apparently they lose one a year, as you just said.
I mean, you know, it's breathtaking. I guess the latest thing I heard, they're thinking, they're actually, somebody also put out a list of, landing strips, within several thousand miles that it might have. I mean, who knows? It could be on the ground somewhere.
Well, it takes about a mile runway to land it, right?
Something like that, yeah. And I mean, but, at this point, here we are, I think we're day 10 now.
Yeah.
And they don't have a clue. They don't have a clue.
Do you think, did it start with getting misinformation from the Malaysian government?
Well, I think it's pretty clear that was a huge problem. I mean, they spent, 3 days looking in, what was obviously the wrong place.
And the Malaysian government knew that, right?
Well, I don't know if they knew it I don't know if you can accuse them of knowing it, but certainly if they'd put all the information they had on the table, there were people who could have said, you're looking in the wrong place.
Talking with Anthony Mason from CBS News about where the plane is, we don't know. So.
There are a lot of people in the world who are very good at finding airplanes, and the best thing you can do when something like this happens is bring them all in as quickly as possible.
Now, these planes they lose once a year.
Well, I mean, it goes in, they're obviously of varying different sizes.
Yeah.
And it's not literally one a year. It's like if you average them out over the last 20, 30 years, it comes to that. But I was surprised. But it took them, what was it, the Air France plane a few years ago, it took them 2 years to actually find the aircraft. They found debris within a number of days, but it took them 2 years to find the aircraft on the bottom of the ocean.
Well, they knew where to look, right?
Yes, they knew. Well, but that just goes to show you, even though they knew it had gone into the water,
yeah,
it still took them 2 years to find it.
So we don't know if this. We don't know where this is.
No, we don't know. We could be on the ground somewhere. I mean, I think that's a little bit of a reach. But 10 days into this, they haven't been really able to rule out much of anything yet.
So let me talk to you now, digressing here, about your musical Mount Rushmore. And
I got two wrong, as if it was a quiz.
Well, here's the problem we have is that, as Lou Ruffino points out, is I ask people for their musical Mount Rushmores, and then if they don't agree with mine, then I take issue with it, which is something I should not do. So,
well, part of the problem is you've only got four slots, and it's pretty tough to, I mean, unless you decide you're going to, you know, put 20 faces on your Mount Rushmore, it was very difficult to pick.
Well, the Beatles and Frank Sinatra, that's, I mean, they would be on anybody's list.
Oh, I know a lot of people who wouldn't put Sinatra there.
Really?
Yeah. I mean, I think they're wrong, but I think a lot of people would look past him.
How about Elvis?
Well, Elvis belongs there, too. I mean, there's no question. I mean, Dylan belongs there, too. There's a lot of people that belong there. But, I mean, the way I edited this was, it's like, all right, I want what I think is the, you know, which is by far the greatest female singer of my lifetime in the past 75 years. That's Aretha. That's easy for me.
Yeah.
And then I thought, all right, I should put what I think of as the best male singer, and that to me is Sinatra. Best group, the Beatles. Most influential group, the Beatles. And most influential guitar player, which is Hendrix. But I could make 20 different Mount Rushmores, and I don't think any of them would be wrong.
Well, I don't know how you make a case for Hendrix, but I guess you do. So.
You don't know how I make it? Oh, well, I don't know. I mean, I'm amazed at how influential he still is. And I think he did more. I think there are a lot of reasons I like Hendrix. But I could, you know, there are four or five other guitar players I could replace him with. And
well, every time they do one of these lists of the greatest guitar players, he's always number one.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah. But I could put Jimmy Page up there. You know, you could put
Stevie Ray Vaughan.
Sorry?
Stevie Ray Vaughan.
Oh, sure. Yeah. I mean, there's.
How about Duane Allman?
Yep. Duane Allman. Absolutely.
Yeah.
By the way, speaking of Duane Allman, just let me, parenthetically, I interviewed his daughter last week, who's written a book.
Yeah.
And I know there are tons of music books out there, and most of them are not very good. Hers is spectacular.
Oh, it is.
I was never a huge Allman Brothers fan. But her father died, I think, when she was two, and her parents split when she was, I think, one. And she's like, I think in her early 40s now, and she went back to sort of find her father and in the process also write a story about the band, both the band itself as a family and the Allmans as a family, and then sort of the family around the band, meaning all the women and everything. And it's an extremely rich book. It's just, it's even if you're not an Allman Brothers fan, if you like music at all, it's a great book.
How do you pronounce her name?
Galadriel.
And how is she as an interview?
She's extremely smart. She's a wonderful writer. And that's the issue I have with a lot of these music books is they're great stories, but very often they're just not very well written, even sometimes by great songwriters. And but she's a really wonderful writer and a very acute observer. And she builds the whole structure of the two guys, of Duane and Greg, very well along with their mother, because Duane's what's interesting also about this is not only did she lose her father, you know, when
he was 24,
he lost his father, Duane did, when he was almost her age. So wow. There's some sort of interesting parallels.
She was supposed to be on here one morning with Greg, and I don't know what happened to him.
Oh, really?
No.
Oh, you know what? Was this like a week or so ago?
Yeah.
He was supposed to be with us in the interview too, and we were told he wasn't feeling well that day.
But you thought she was great.
I thought she was really good, and I picked up the book. It was one of about 10 things I had to do that week, and I thought I'll skim through this because I really don't have time, and I couldn't skim through it. It was so good, I just kept reading, and I ended up reading the whole book.
Happy St. Patrick's Day, by the way.
Thank you very much, and you too.
Anthony Mason, so we spent all morning and nothing.
Well, no, we told you we came up with those ideas. We were out.
The other idea was mine. About interviewing the guests and stuff, in my email I sent to you.
But we could actually make it like, you know, like a thing with a character or something on the couch with or whatever,
right?
You know. And I wrote a Jay Leno on St. Patrick's Day.
Well, that's
the blog.
That's something you wrote this morning.
Yeah.
As per your request.
What?
As per your request.
I got to cut somebody from the Might Be Elvis.
Well, guns, obviously.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, he wasn't part of it.
Didn't bring much to the table.
Trevor's a regular.
Well, Trevor's definitely coming back, right?
Who filled in for Trevor?
Guns.
Guns.
Right.
Right. Okay, so we still got to cut somebody.
Ah.
So Trevor would be back. Right. But somebody else has got to go.
Hmm.
Hmm.
Wonder who it could be.
I don't know. It's really difficult.
Who he's talking about.
Yeah, I don't know. Yeah.
We don't need my pick, by the way.
No.
So I'm out. No.
Oh, there you go. That's it.
Okay.
No, we need one more.
Oh, we have to cut two people.
Yeah. Well, we're not counting me.
Well, Rob stays, but doesn't.
Dwayne Allman, who was killed in a motorcycle accident, and I believe he was just 24, was one of the great guitar players ever, I believe. So good that he quit high school, I believe, just to stay home and practice, figure it out, you know. So he was so good, he was playing on all these records that they were doing down there at Muscle Shoals, you know, and other places. Records by Aretha Franklin and all these other people. So, and he played on, Wilson Pickett did a version of Hey Jude. And generally, Wilson Pickett can take a song and ruin it by screaming, which is what he's most famous for. He had a couple of hits, and then everything else he ruined by screaming for no reason. So, but it's not a bad version of Hey Jude. But and Dwayne Allman played guitar on it. And they say that the guitar solo at the end of this Hey Jude was so impressive. Is that you, Warner?
No, wait a minute.
Wow. Did you want something, Warner?
No, sorry.
We're keeping you up. We're keeping you up?
No, I was asking. I didn't realize a mic. I was asking.
Well, why don't you shut the mic off?
That's right.
Good plan. Excellent plan. Could have been a lot worse.
Oh my God, my mind's reeling with what could have happened.
No, he's really enjoying this story.
Yeah, you don't want to hear about Dwayne Allman, huh?
No, it had nothing to do with that. Oh, I was asking Guns.
How much longer is this going on, Guns?
No,
it's going to be a rodeo.
Oh my God,
Wilson Pickett and Dwayne Allman. Wow, Guns.
Hoagie Carmichael.
So apparently, and you know, somebody died here a while back. I just signed the papers the other day and left over $500,000 to the ranch.
Unbelievable.
That's
so bizarre. Which leads me to this announcement.
What?
If you're old.
Oh, no. Right?
And you've got a lot of money.
Yeah.
And a bunch of ungrateful thieving relatives who just can't wait for you to die. It's like these reverse mortgage deals.
Uh-huh.
Hey.
Yeah. Right.
Cost me $1.7 million a year to run this ranch.
Get it in the will.
You know, and Leslie's a slender. She helps us raise a lot of money at ABC
right.
And Fox through the golf tournament, the radiothon, and the Broadway thing. But sometimes we come up short. You know who has to make that up?
Uh-huh.
I do.
Uh-huh.
Right. So thanks in advance.
Yeah. So well, why not call, what's his name, get that will changed, and then check out.
And then check out.
Get off the planet.
In that order, right.